He'll be using an old Snoop Dogg CD to finish that lot work.
Now wait just one minizzle.
Satisfaction guaranteed for 90 days or your money back.
This is your test. Every path you have trod through wilderness, through war, led to this road.
Come, Martha. Come,
The Rings, The Return of the King, rated PG-13, December 17th.
All right, King Rookie, how about a little one-on-one? No? Didn't think so. I can't
get enough. The NBA on ABC premieres Christmas Day. Can't get enough.
Winning team is sort of like molding a lump of clay. Now follow me on this one. So you need time to shape it and work with it until you have a well-made finished product, right? Well, Carmelo Anthony and Ryan Bowen are trying to help build a winner in Denver. So they rolled up their sleeves and did some molding of their own.
Today we have a few special guests to take a craft with you. We have Ryan Bowen.
Bowen on a run out. And Ryan will.
And Carmelo Anthony.
How you doing?
Three on two for the Nuggets.
Yo, DJ, spin that wheel. Spin that wheel. Spin that wheel.
Oh, it's just great to get out in the community and, you know, there's more to it than just playing basketball. There's a lot of other things that we can do to be role models. That's what it's really all about.
That's a real soft on the side.
There you go. Good job.
I think I'm doing a pretty good job.
Slow that down, Carmelo. That'd be going too fast.
Oh, yeah?
There you go. Good. That's a better speed.
Yeah, you get a hang of it, man. You get a hang of it.
Keep wetting your hands because your hands are going
to
get sticky.
It's important for us to get out into the community, be up close and personal with the kids.
I mean, just interacting with the kids and playing with clay. I know they like to play with clay because I did when I was growing up. So. Like clay? Yeah.
I think a lot of the kids didn't think they could do something like this, and it's amazing to see how it forms and to see the different ideas that the kids have.
I don't know what I just made.
I'm not really sure what we're making, but we did something, didn't we, Lainey? Yeah. To see them get such joy, you know, work with you really put a smile on your face, and so that's really what it's all about.
The kids got to keep their pottery while Carmelo's and Ryan's will be auctioned off at Chopper's Dinner, a Nuggets fundraiser that'll be held in February.
That is our show for today. We'll see you next week with more Inside Stuff.
So long, everybody.
I think we'll go out there and say that.
You're watching ABC, America's broadcasting company. Weekday afternoons at 4, followed by News Source 13 at 5 on WOKR 13.
Thank you for doing business with the Ralph family.
For 70 years, please join us in taking pride in Rochester.
I can't believe it. We worked so hard. Where did all of our money go?
Gambling a problem? Call this number now. With locations in Rochester, Farmington, Geneseo, Newark, and Hornell. Continuing the tradition.
Here we go! See you later! He's got it on the record! Touchdown! Touchdown!
ABC Sports. Championship Television. During the next 10 hours, the remaining pieces of the national title will come together. In prime time, the Big 12 championship and a trip to the national title game is at stake for the nation's lone remaining unbeaten team. Oklahoma quarterback Jason White is determined to make one last statement on the national stage, punctuating his Heisman campaign. For the number one Sooners, Kansas State is the last piece of their puzzle. At 4:30 Eastern, we'll see if the young, brash, and confident Trojans can hang on to their spot in the national championship game. Is Conference Foe Oregon State the answer to the BCS riddle for USC? Coming up next, Notre Dame rolls into Central New York to take on Syracuse. A fourth straight victory for the Irish helps USC standing in the complicated brain teaser that is the BCS. A season-long puzzle takes shape next on ABC Sports.
And welcome to the Built for Tough pregame show. A storm has hit the Northeast, and we hope that storm spreads all across the country and everybody stays indoors to watch college football because it's an unbelievable day. John Saunders, Terry Bowden, and Craig James. When have we ever seen a pair of 5-6 teams that could affect the outcome of the national championship? Yeah,
it's unbelievable. I mean, Notre Dame needs to win so that they can help USC out in the strength of schedule bonanza thing that's going on, and they've got their work cut out for them today at Syracuse.
Again, you just say, just win on the field. If USC and LSU just win, that's not enough. Notre Dame has to win.
We still don't know what's going on, but we'll try and keep you up to date. We'll see you at halftime as well. Right now, let's join Brad Nessler.
All right, fellas, welcome to the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. Nice and toasty in here, not the case outside. For the first time in 40 years, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame and the Orangemen of Syracuse get set to go to battle on the football field. It's been since 1963 the last time they got together. Welcome, everybody. Brad Nessler and Bob Gracie, along with Lynn Swann, who's outside right now. We'll check in with Swanee in a minute. The guys already talked about the BCS impact of this ball game. For the two coaches who know there's no bowl game in the future for these two teams, they're kind of approaching this as their bowl game.
Well, Tyrone Willingham has got his Irish playing very well. Offensively, they're scoring at record heights the last three games. Defensively, they're playing very well. Next year, when they start football practice, they'll look back on this season, and hopefully they'll win this game and finish on a real high note.
Paul Pasqualoni's team, meanwhile, has lost three straight, and they're trying to avoid a second straight losing season. A lot of people think this is even a battle for his job.
Well, he's approaching it in the right way. He's told his guys, hey, it's December. We're at home. It's a national opponent, Notre Dame, on national television. This is our bowl game. Talking to Paul on the field before the game, he's heard all of the innuendos and everything. He says, I'd not rather be any place than right here coaching a football game. That's all he's thinking about is this game.
And he's got 16 seniors he hopes to send out on a good note as they have an opportunity to beat the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Time to salt down the sidewalk. If you're tailgating, stay warm. And if you need something inside you, I don't know if that's Syracuse soup or Irish stew, but they've got it going outside the Carrier Dome.
Game soup. We got all soup. We got all
the Built Ford Tough pregame, brought to you by the next Ford F-150. Bigger, stronger, smoother. Only one truck earned the right to be the next F-150. We'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Only one truck has the strongest, toughest frame of any full-size pickup. That truck is the new Ford F-150. It has a fully boxed frame with crossbars welded through the side rails, all of which gives you the highest payload. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Oh, yeah!
Welcome to the concrete jungle! Get your hands off my tools, huh? Huh? Where you at? Huh? What you looking around for? No backup! I got you! Who your daddy? Who your dad?
Inside Scoop. I'll be your host as ABC looks at the greatest championship moments of the year.
Sunday, 3:30 Eastern on ABC.
Something new from Chase Pitkin. Conserve energy and save money with this Intermatic outdoor timer. Set your holiday lights with two on-off programs per day. With Chase Pickens' sale price and a mail-in rebate, you'll want more than one. Get a first look at Chase Pickens.
Here's a question. If you needed your insurance, who would you call? Not the name of the company, but the name of the person. You've got 2 seconds. Coming up blank, you may want to consider Allstate. You'd have a local agent you can count on, a licensed professional whose name you know, not just a number. You deserve a relationship with a real person. That's Allstate Stand. Are you in good hands?
It's no secret. The cost of petroleum-based energy products can be unpredictable. Now more than ever, it's important to protect yourself and your family from constantly changing fuel costs. We've got a complete line of top-brand wood, gas, and pellet stoves. Plus, you'll discover one of the area's nicest selection of fireplaces and fireplace inserts. What could be more inviting this winter than sitting in front of a cozy big ash stove or fireplace and lowering your home heating costs at the same time? Big Ash Stoves of Holly. Take a first look at something new from Chase Pitkin. This new combo alarm from Kiddo detects both smoke and carbon monoxide with voice warning.
Fire, fire.
It combines two important types of safety alarms in one unit. Get a first look at Chase Pitkin.
Plan your day with an accurate weather forecast. Turn to 13, the Weather Authority.
Welcome back. I'm Lynn Swan with ABC Sports and a national weather update. At the Coliseum, it's 58 degrees with a chance of rain. At Arrowhead Stadium, well, it's in the low 40s or mid-30s, and it's going to be a windy evening. And in Syracuse, New York, well, according to this thermometer, it's 25 degrees, and as you can see, the snow is falling. But inside the Carrier Dome, it is a perfect 68 degrees. As you've heard, this game is about pride, and we expect a really physical contest. But on the last day of the regular college football season, there are other national stories. Weather providing and technology permitting, we'll have the new head coach of Mississippi State, Sylvester Croom, in a live interview. So for those of you who have not gone out and finished your Christmas shopping, stay at home, relax, put your feet up, light the fire. We've got some great football action ahead.
Hey, DVDs, what did you get?
CDs!
Video games.
Oh, I wanted
cool.
That one, too.
That's such a good one.
Store opens in 20 minutes, Pete. Focus.
Right. Okay.
All the new stuff. Stop by Circuit City every Tuesday and save on the hottest new releases. Like Bad Boys 2 on DVD, a two-disc set for just $15.99. Save on great gifts and dash through your list today at Circuit City. We're with you.
I love this land. It's been part of this family for over two generations. We know every acre of it because we've been managing all of this for over 30 years. My name is Sue Harshman. I'm a banker, and I'm proud to be part of the private bank of Bank of America. Many people are surprised to hear about a private bank managing this type of property, but you develop the breadth and depth of expertise when you're entrusted to manage today's complex wealth for so many families and individuals across America. Most of our clients are self-made. We advise them on how to preserve what they built for the next generation and their families. We help them create the trust to protect it for a long, long time. And along the way, we help invest their money to protect it, to manage it, and to help it grow, just as we've been doing for private bank clients for the past 150 years. Just look at this land.
Bank of America, higher standards.
FedEx. FedEx. Hello?
FedEx Express. All you need to know when shipping to Asia.
Freshman quarterback Brady Quinn for Notre Dame warming up as the 5-6 Fighting Irish try to win their fourth straight ball game against Syracuse, a team that has lost its last three and is 2-5 in the Big East. Syracuse won the toss and deferred, so Notre Dame will get their hands on the football first. A fiery introduction of those 16 seniors I was talking about before we went to the break. I thought Scanlon, the middle linebacker, was going to pull something just running out to meet his buddy. So they are fired up about meeting Notre Dame. And as we said, in all for all practical purposes, this is their bowl game.
Well, this is the last time these seniors from Syracuse is going to have the opportunity to go through this drill right here.
So Brendan Carney will tee it up for Syracuse, and Dwight Alec and Matt Shelton will drop back deep. Fourth meeting ever between Syracuse and Notre Dame. Notre Dame's got the edge. The last one they played was at Yankee Stadium. The kick goes to the one to Ellick. Ellick's got a little seam, and it closed in a hurry. Nice open field tackle as he crossed the 21. And Brady Quinn comes out. There's his numbers on his freshman season. He's going to be a good one.
Brady Quinn has gradually improved throughout the season. We saw his first start back against Purdue in the, I think it was the fourth game of the year. Only 19 years old, just had his birthday, so he's learning on the run.
He threw 47 passes in that game that Bob's talking about against Purdue, and I'd say on about half of them, he took it right in the chin from the defense every time he let it go. But he kept getting back up.
Hit a lot, you're right.
From the 22, Notre Dame, first down. And play action. Quinn wants it all. Going deep. Got a man out there. Incomplete. Nice play made at the last moment. Carlisle Holiday, who started the season at quarterback, was the intended receiver. And a nice job by Steve Gregory to stay with him in the secondary. Here's the big eaters for Notre Dame up front. Molinaro, Lavore, Morton, Stevenson, and Ryan Harris, another freshman now who's starting at right tackle. Julius Jones has been on a tear. We'll talk about that as we go. Powers Neal, the fullback, Palmer, the tight end, McKnight, and Jenkins, the starting wide receivers. But as we said, on the first snap of the ball game, they were trying to go along to Carlisle Holiday.
Bill Diedrich, the offensive coordinator, says, we think we can throw deep on this Syracuse defensive backfield.
They tried to find out right away, didn't they? Here's Julius Jones. He's had three 200-yard-plus games this season. He got about four. It'll be third down at six against this defense. Thomas, Ferrara, Gashlin, all seniors, and James Weiss, who they say is going to be the next great defensive lineman here. Rich Scanlon, that's the middle linebacker I talked about. He's the leading tackler. Smith and Pruitt flank him in the secondary. As Bob said, they think they can take advantage, maybe, in this game. Gregory, Larry, Smith, and Schwittenberg. And there's Scanlon. The leading tackler, 139 stops coming in. He's one of the seniors and a captain. Third down, a long six, Notre Dame on their opening possession of the ball game. Quinn, quick drop over the middle, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Smith. Just like that, Syracuse comes up with a big play.
Anthony Smith, who leads this team in interceptions, that's his fourth on the year. They were ready for this. They knew what Notre Dame wanted to do, so they dropped Smith into a little robber position. Number 20, a seam right there in the middle of your screen. He's expecting somebody to cross. He cuts in front of Jenkins and picks it off.
So the offensive Syracuse will take over in a great spot at the Notre Dame 24. And they'll bring out their senior captain and quarterback, R.J. Anderson. He'll take the field with the offense. He talked about playing Notre Dame.
This is a team in college football, personally. They have a great reputation. They have a great tradition. And we just want to come out here on national TV at home. Let's play, and let's get a win.
They start off in good fashion. They go to the other offensive captain, the fullback, Thump Belton. So first completion for RJ, and he's only a couple completions away from having a single season mark in that capacity.
32nd start of his career. 17 and 14 as a starter, but this is an experienced quarterback. Didn't start a lot of games last year, 2 years ago, and before that, but he's an experienced hand.
Second down and four inside the red zone already for Syracuse, courtesy of the interception. Anderson, quick throw again, complete. Inside the 15, down near the 12 to Jaron Jones, and it's going to be a first down. Here's the lineup offensively up front, the big fellas. For the Orangemen, Terry and Sampson, the tackles, Terullo, Franklin, and Nick Romeo making his 48th straight start. That's only one behind Donovan McNabb, the all-time record holder. Reyes and Belton in the backfield. Cusimano, Morant, and Jones round out the receiving core, and Syracuse has a first down inside the Notre Dame 15. Reyes hasn't touched it yet. He's the single setback behind Anderson. On first down, we'll touch it this time. Touch to the right side, inside the 10. Got a blocker. Almost a touchdown for Reyes on his first carry. Down to the 1. The wide receiver got a great block.
He did. He did, Brad. The offensive line, first of all, on the right side, is going to get something done right over here. Watch the blocking on the right side. And then the receiver on the right side, Morant's going to come in and do something. Big blocking there. Now right there. Right there is Morant, number two, goes all over the defensive back and springs Reyes on a almost scored.
First down and goal at the one. Reyes has 15 rushing touchdowns this year. He won't get number 16 on this carry. Nice job defensively by Courtney Watson. The defense for Notre Dame trying to be fired up right now. Here's their front four. Justin Tuck, their leading sack man. Campbell and Hilliard inside are strong. Avi Amiri is a freshman. Hoyt and Curry flank Watson in the linebacking core. The secondary is a good one. Some question marks about Vontaze Duff because of a slight injury. Burrell, Bible, and Ellick round out the backfield there.
He did start, though. Ty Willingham telling me before the game he didn't know whether or not he was going to play. Don't know how long he's going. He's got a pulled stomach muscle that it amounts to.
Reyes this time is in. Touchdown, Syracuse. 2 yard route. They went with a full house backfield, and he almost walked in. Boy, that's the way you wake up the crowd on an early Saturday afternoon when it's snowing outside.
And a tip of the hat to Anthony Smith, the free safety who picked off the interception to give them a nice short field for their first drive.
The Reyes 16th touchdown rushing of the year. Makes it 6-0. Orangemen and Colin Barber in for the point after. Both teams use the old swinging gate as they line up their offense and now move in front of their kicker. And just 3 minutes into the ball game, Syracuse has shocked the Irish a bit with an early touchdown. Extra point is up and good. 11:55 remaining first quarter. As Bob said, that guy is the one that did most of the job, Anthony Smith. And then his offense took over, and Walter Reyes paid it off. 7-0 Syracuse.
Taco Bell's fajita grilled stuffed burrito. Sizzling marinated carne asada steak and tasty fajita veggies. Wrapped and grilled to go.
I should have gotten fajitas.
Ooh, fajitas.
Nothing beats the sizzle when you think outside the bun.
That's not Santa. That's 40 million jolly customers who know their financial stockings are stuffed. Insurance, loans, retirement. AIG. We know money.
Just a little love. Think of your fellow man. Send him a helping hand.
Trust.
Oh, hello.
When crooks pose as cops.
Let me see your badge.
Everything's cool.
Get down!
New 10-8, ABC Sunday, 8-7 Central.
A Nissan scoring drive. Syracuse didn't have to drive far. 24 yards following the interception. Reyes' 16th rushing touchdown of the year. Carney's kick will go. Who's going to take it? Shelton at about the 3. Syracuse. Go back to the touchdown.
Reyes is thanking his fullback. Thump Belton right here. Watch the block he's going to get on the defensive lineman. Right here.
Oh, man.
Right here. Look at the block. I don't think he was expecting Hilliard, one of the best defensive players on Notre Dame's side, to be there that quickly. I think he was looking for a linebacker, and the defensive tackle, 300-pounder, showed up, so he just had to take
it. I tell you what, he took him. Hilliard almost ended up with whiplash after that one. Second straight start for Notre Dame, and it's on 22-yard line. Jones, the tailback of the eye, trying to cut it outside, now brings it back inside, and he's met by Lewis Gashlin and company. Scanlon's there as well.
Well, this is a perfect start for Syracuse. This is exactly what they needed. They've lost their last three. They've come back to the home place, their dome, where they play their best football, and then they've got an interception and a quick touchdown. Notre Dame on the other side, last week against Stanford, they were up 21-0 at the end of the first quarter.
So definitely a big time turnaround from what Notre Dame experienced a week ago. Second down and 9. Irish just inside the 43. Quinn pump fakes. Wanted to go long again. Now comes back to his safety valve. Jones on the near side. And Jones gets what he can, and he's run out after a pickup of only a couple. Josh Thomas, the defensive end, and Scanlon again, the middle linebacker, run him down.
Brady Quinn wanted to throw to one or the other of his wide receivers. They thought they were going to have single coverage. They were both double coverage, so he came off of them and just dumped it off to Jones. But this is what Notre Dame wants to do, attack the outside corners with their receivers.
Carla Holiday is checked back in as an extra receiver. Notre Dame's been struggling at times, though their offense has been good the last two or three weeks, still 90th in the country. And they've got a third down and long here. Third down and 7. Ryan Grant now the single setback. 3 wide outs for Quinn. Syracuse looks like it might bring some heat. Nope, they'll come with a straight rush, and it's a handoff. And it's a first down and a lot more. Ryan Grant almost broke it. Grant was the starter at the early part of this season, and he's had a tremendous year, but he hasn't been getting many snaps since Julius Jones has been on such a tear.
Well, that's a good call offensively. Dietrich, the offensive coordinator, third and long. Watch the left tackle. That's Molinaro, number 70, comes right through the hole. Look at this. He has to run through on third and long. Now watch 20. Anthony Smith comes up and just throws himself, misses the block, and that's what allowed him to pick up the first down.
And all the way out across the 45-yard line. Pick up of 21. Now Jones back in there. Got about a yard and a half, and then he got tagged by James Weish, just a sophomore, number 90, and defensive coordinator telling us that this is the next star on this defense.
Yeah. Talking to Chris Ripon yesterday, he said Weish is going to be a star, but the defensive backs, the two safeties, including Anthony Smith, they're going to be good. They're just young puppies. They moved them from different positions, and they just need some experience back there.
Grant now checks back in for the Irish backfield. Second down and 8. At the 48. And he'll get the call. The second man through again. Busts out close to a first down. He's to the 45 of Syracuse, about a yard shy of the first down. So Grant getting some early touches, and he's making them count.
Well, one of the reasons for the turnaround in this running game for Notre Dame is their offensive line. All 5 starters from last year are gone, 4 of them to the NFL, and one of them, Sean Milligan, to back injury. All 5 of them are new, and they've come alive.
And since they put Harris in, the true freshman, at right tackle, and then shifted some other personnel to beef up the inside, they've been strong. Third and a yard. Grant has got it. Or it appears he does. He might have to bring the chains out to look. Only needed about a yard, and if they're standing where the spot's going to be, you're going to see those chains on the far side move to a first down. So Notre Dame gave up the early touchdown. Jim Lapatino's our referee as he signals first down. Second time now on third down they've gone to the ground and gotten a first down.
No, Ty wasn't waving. He wasn't waving at somebody. He was giving the personnel formation. You know, whether it's going to be 2 wide receivers or 3 tight ends or 2 backs or 1 back, that hand in the air like that is a signal for a formation so people can get in and out of the game quickly.
7th play of the Irish drive now at the Orangemen 44. Quinn play action. This time he fires it far side. He had a man open. He overshot McKnight. McKnight had a step over there. Look, Quinn got a little bit too much on it.
Things are not going well early for Notre Dame on their wide receivers picking on the corners. Early, the first play of the game, they threw long to Holiday and just missed it. A couple of plays after that, they tried a little out and up, which was not there.
Yep.
Now this one, they just said, all right, we'll just throw an out in front of him. Well, they didn't hit that either. You got to hit some of this stuff short before those corners are going to bite on it.
Shelton and Holiday now, the wide receivers. Shelton to the top of your screen. They'll keep it on the ground again. It's Grant. This time up the middle to about the 41. He picked up three. It'll still bring up another third down and long situation. Coming up tomorrow, John Terry and Craig will be in Times Square Stadium to reveal which teams will battle for the national championship, plus all the other bowl series matchups. Tostitas BCS selection show tomorrow, live at 5:30 Eastern, 2:30 Pacific, right here on ABC. Fellas will clear it all up for you tomorrow.
All the wondering all year long, all the ifs, ands, and buts, and all that stuff. And we'll talk to get it all squared away.
Another third down and seven. So far, it's all been on the ground. And they'll try it again. And Jones broke free, but he didn't get the first down. Might be decision time, though. They might think about going on fourth and one. They're at the 35-yard line.
Well, I think you go for it. The field goal is too long for you. It's the last game of the season. You know, it's not bad field position if you don't make it.
They'll bring in the extra tight ends. They're thinking like we are. Notre Dame, that is. And they'll go at the 35. They're 43%, which isn't too bad on fourth down conversions. And they've gone several times this year.
It's Chris Ripon,
defensive coordinator. It's Jones in at the tailback spot. Fourth and one, Notre Dame. Trailing by a touchdown. Jones hit in the backfield, and down he goes. Chris Ferrara. Great penetration by the senior defensive tackle, and the Orangemen will take over. So Notre Dame goes on fourth and one, and they actually lose yardage on the play. Nice job by the Syracuse defense. They'll give it back to their offense with a 7-point lead when we come back.
Navy Holiday Hotline. Eyes of Blue. I'll connect you. Hot pink, I should think. Quit monkeying around. How about a little logo? Go-go.
That look is off the hook.
Yeah, and my shizzle's gone for zizzle.
Half zips make great gifts for the whole family. Just $10 to $15.
And taste. This calls for Killian's.
College football brought to you by SBC, going beyond the call. Nissan, who invite you to shift the way through the world. And Bank of America, higher standards. We're getting higher snowfall outside the Carrier Dome. The 500 Bowl, huh? Whoever wins will be 500 when this one's over.
Yeah.
So Syracuse takes over on downs. Nice job by their defense stopping Julius Jones short of the first down. And R.J. Anderson takes back over for the Orangemen offense. Their own 37. A little option. Here's a toss to Reyes. Wally's got the corner and just glides out of bounds near a first down. Smooth runner. Had a great start to the year and was leading the nation in rushing for several weeks. And he's tailed off a little bit. Their offensive linemen, for the most part, have to play every snap, and I think they're wearing down a little bit as the season's gone along.
First option of the game on Curry, number 49, talking yesterday. We're to expect between 5 and 10 options from this offense per game, according to George DeLeon, the offensive coordinator. It's a nightmare for a defensive
coordinator to prepare for.
You see how close they are on second down, and the fullback's got it, and then some. Bump Felton, who had the nice block on the touchdown run, gets a little sugar of his own, and he carries it down to the 46.
What a name for a fullback.
I love that. And Justin Tuck is the injured Notre Dame player, and he is one of the best in the country, not just on that Notre Dame side of the ball.
Well, he had four sacks in the game last week against Stanford.
And 13 on the season.
This is artificial turf. I think he may have just caught his leg on the turf.
We'll check on him when we come back. 6:33, a concerned Ty Willingham looking up.
Last Thanksgiving, about 2 million people tried to deep-fat fry their turkey. 15 succeeded in setting their houses on fire. At Christmas, there was a lot of driving over the river and through the woods and a little bit of skidding on the ice and taking out Grandma's garage door. So while you're celebrating, Allstate will be standing by. Trouble never takes the holiday. Neither should your insurance. That's Allstate's stance. Are you in good hands?
We combine our famous chicken crispers, buffalo wings, and southwestern egg rolls to create the triple play appetizer. Want more flavor? Come to Chili's.
There's more to protecting your family this winter than making sure they're dressed warmly. You've got to make sure they're protected at home as well. And no one helps protect families better than ADT. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide. Call now and take advantage of ADT's holiday special. You could even save up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance. And you may qualify for zero down financing for installation. But you better hurry. ADT. Always there.
Let me get this straight. So you want fast heartburn relief. You want something that lasts, and you don't like taking all that prescription strength stuff. Well, this is your lucky day.
New Tums Lasting Effects. It's fast, it lasts.
You're my best friend. I love you.
If you betray her, I will kill you.
I found the marksman.
A new alias, ABC Sunday, 9, 8 Central.
Take a look at the play, the injury to Justin Tuck.
Right here.
Knee just sort of buckles on him as he's helping to make the tackle on Thump Belton.
That's the tough part of the artificial turf. Notre Dame does not play on it that often. Shoe gets caught in the turf.
Meanwhile, Syracuse offensively with a first down and a 7-0 lead. Nice play fake. Anderson comes up throwing the other way, goes right back to his fullback Belton, and he goes down the sideline out of bounds, and he's got another first down. Ty Willingham in his second year as head coach at Notre Dame, and he had some comments about the newest head coach in college football, Sylvester Croom.
He is a knowledgeable football man, so he brings great expertise to the job. Then, if you care to, you can add in color. Okay, he is an African American, and at that particular region of our country, there is a lot of history of denying access to all systems, not just athletic systems.
We'll talk to Coach Groom right after this play as Anderson comes up throwing out to Johnny Morant, and he's got a pickup of about 5. We want to welcome the newest member of college football and the newest coaching addition to the Southeastern Conference. Sylvester Croom joins us live, and Coach, we want to congratulate you. Welcome back to the SEC, where not only a star player at Alabama, a longtime coach there. After the Alabama job didn't come your way last year, Coach, did you ever think you're going to get another shot like this?
Well, I didn't anticipate this one coming this soon, but I'm very fortunate to have it, and I'm very happy being at Mississippi State University.
The play, and then we'll go back to Coach Croom. Second down and 4. At the 25 of Notre Dame, and they'll blow this one dead. Penalty on the play. That's the first penalty of the ball game.
Offense. All right, here a penalty. Go second down.
And back to Coach Croom.
Coach, you played at Alabama. You coached there for 10 or 11 years. You were in the NFL for over 15 years. Over that span, which coach has had the biggest influence on you in your coaching style and the way you do things?
Well, of course, that's an easy question. Having played for Coach Bryant and coached for him, that was a big impact on me. And the time I spent with Coach Ross, that also was a big impact on me.
Incomplete pass. Almost a touchdown over in the corner to Jared Jones. Swanee?
Well, Coach, I know how important it is that you have a head coaching job and you're prepared for this. But let me ask you what you think is most important, the fact that you got a head coaching job or the fact that you were able to break down the barrier in the SEC by being the first African-American head coach in that conference.
Well, the most important thing to me, of course, is having a chance to be a head football coach. The fact that I'm a minority in this position, particularly in the SEC, and the impact that it has, I think that's a byproduct of that.
On a third and long, pass is thrown short to Belton, the fullback, and he gets hit at about the 25. Coach, your biggest hurdle, do you think? You got a lot of work to do, and you know that. What's going to be the biggest part of the job?
Well, the first thing is getting our staff together, talking with all the a lot of the first-time head coaches that I've talked to over the last week or so. That was their feeling, and I'm experiencing that right now. It's getting a staff together and hitting the ground recruiting, and plus the fact that I'm still an employee of the Green Bay Packers as well.
Yeah, we weren't going to overlook that part. We know you still got some work to do in that capacity. Is the field goal unit on? Colin Barber trying a 42-yard kick. And he's got it. 10-0, Syracuse.
Coach, how are you spending your time during the week? And I know you're trying to do some things with Green Bay, but also be involved down there at Mississippi State.
Well, the early part of the week, I'm involved in game planning at Green Bay, and the latter part and at night, I usually spend time talking with coaches, people who I'm interviewing for our coaching staff, as well as calling prospects. Then in the latter part of the week, I come down to Starkville and get involved in recruiting here as well, and finishing our staff out.
Have you made any decisions on who you might add on your staff so far?
Well, we've made some decisions, and we'll be announcing those in the early part of next week.
Well, Coach, you've got a great reputation for working with running backs where every place you've gone. What kind of offense are you hoping to build at Mississippi State?
Well, we like to install the same system we're using at Green Bay, our version of the West Coast offense there, because it does give us flexibility to incorporate whatever kind of quarterback that we're fortunate to, the ones that we have and the ones that we're recruiting here at Mississippi State. It'll be very multiple. We'll run the football, but we'll throw the ball just like we do at Green Bay, a lot of movement passes, a lot of three- and five-step drop game, a lot of play-action game. And it'll give us flexibility as far as getting the best players on the field.
Well, Coach, you know, we've seen a lot of coaches come into the college ranks wanting to put in the West Coast offense. It seems like it's awfully difficult for some of the college kids to grab onto that system. Do you have a nucleus, you think, that will be able to adapt very quickly to that system?
Well, the thing we'll do is the thing I think we've done very well at Green Bay is have flexibility. We don't have to, of course, we will go slowly in it. We'll put the core plays in. We'll execute them and teach them with the same discipline that we do at the pro level. But we will definitely not have as many plays as we do at the pro level. We just don't have the time to do it.
Coach, we know how much work you've got to do and what's ahead of you, and we know your time is valuable. We really appreciate you being along with us. We just want to say congratulations. Welcome back to college football.
Best of luck, Coach.
Thank you very much.
There's the new head coach at Mississippi State. Good to have him back. He's got two jobs going on. You know, the one thing you say about Starkville, the cheese won't be as fresh as it is in Green Bay, but the barbecue's better. Meanwhile, we've had just a field goal that's going on, and you saw it, a 42-yarder. It's 10-0. Syracuse in front of Notre Dame. Notre Dame with a second down and 10 at the 25-yard line. Quinn still trying to hook up a first down pass. They keep it on the ground, though, and Jones is finding the sledding tough. Grant's actually done a better job out of the backfield than Julius has so far. He's got 7 carries for only 10 yards. Sylvester Kroom, we talked about where he's been. He's an all-conference performer as a player at Alabama before coaching under Coach Bryant, and then went with Ray Perkins when he took over for Bryant to Tampa Bay. That's how he got in the National Football League, and then has been with the Packers for a long time. Yeah, he and Ty Willingham's hookup actually would have been in the NFL, not in college football, because Ty was with Denny Greenstaff in Minnesota when Sylvester was with the Packers for so many years.
I think it's 17 years in the NFL as an assistant and 10 years at Alabama.
He's going to be a good one. A good one for Mississippi State and a good one for Notre Dame. They finally hook up on a first down pass. It's all the way out near midfield to Maurice Stovall.
And impressed with Brady Quinn, the true freshman quarterback, just buying a little extra time. Now, everything was covered downfield, but he saw it was covered. So let me slide around here a little bit, give my receivers a little bit more time to get open, threw the ball on the run, and picked up a big first down.
Remember, they had a pretty good offensive drive going last time before they stalled on a fourth and one when Jones was slammed for a two-yard loss. So now they're right back near midfield. Grant's back in there at the tailback spot. First and 10, Notre Dame. Just under 3 minutes remaining first quarter. Quinn, plenty of time. Fires to Grant out of the backfield. He's got a first down and more down near the 34-yard line. So Quinn's got it working a little bit now, getting better every week, and his head coach talked about his leadership qualities with us.
Probably the most impressive thing is the fact that he gives you such great leadership at a young age. Okay, usually you think that a quarterback to kind of rise to that position has to be a senior to provide the kind of leadership that he's given our football team. But he is a special person, and because of that, our guys flock to him and follow him.
Poise and confidence. Standing and talking with Ty, just watching Brady warm up before the game. He said he's got poise and confidence.
Not an easy thing to do when you're that young and you're still deciding whether you need to shave or not. You got those big linemen up in front of you. To be a leader at that age isn't easy.
Notre Dame has got nothing but upside with this young quarterback. He bit the bullet about 7 or 8 games ago. This is the 9th start for Quinn. So it was this is 9 games ago that they put him in there. They bit the bullet. So let's put him in there, let him learn. Next year and the year after is going to be nothing but bonuses and pluses for putting Brady Quinn in there this year and letting him make some mistakes.
And he's talking about a mistake in the personnel right now. Letting his guys know it. He'll lead them over to the sideline. Timeout Notre Dame. They trail by 10.
Common vision here at Notre Dame. It is about academic excellence and Catholic character. We pass on stories of legendary figures. We hold certain values sacred: education, faith, and service. I'm Father Monk Beloy, and this is Notre Dame.
Two minutes remaining in the first quarter. 10-0 Syracuse. Notre Dame taking a timeout. Either the play that was sent in from the bench or the personnel didn't agree with Brady Quinn, so he took the whole team over there to the sideline to talk things over with Coach Willingham. And now it's second down and 8.
That's what it is most of the time when you see a quarterback call timeout. It's not because of the defense. It's probably wrong alignment by his offense.
Boy, this Syracuse defense is fired up to meet Julius Jones. I'll tell you that much. Jones has been, as we said, a 1,000-yard back for Notre Dame and has had a terrific season. 3 200-plus games this year already, which is a Notre Dame record, and he is paying the price every time he touches it today.
Well, what the game plan for Syracuse defensively is: stop Notre Dame's run and force the true freshman Quinn to beat you through the air.
He'll have to go to the air here, we would assume, but they have run it on third and long a couple of times in the game already. Third and 9. Quinn sets, waits, and almost waited too long, and it's incomplete. Boy, he had a lot of time, and finally Josh Thomas came flying around the corner and just got a hand on him as he was releasing the football.
Well, they had good protection. It's just the fact that they were running deeper routes, and the deeper you run routes, the longer you have to wait for them to break them off.
E.J. Fitzpatrick, his longest field goal this year is 40 yards. They're going to ask him for a 50-yarder here. Took over when Nick Setta was injured earlier this season. Matt Kruger to hold. Fitzpatrick trying to put Notre Dame on the board from 50 yards out. He got a lot of leg into it, and he got it.
Right, perfect. Down, right down Main Street.
Nice kick. So Notre Dame scores for the first time today, and they match the field goal kicked by Colin Barber earlier. 10-3.
Well, this is a big drive for Notre Dame because they had fallen down 10 points. He had enough leg. That was a big kick. This was their third possession, Notre Dame. They hadn't scored in their first two possessions, and that was key to get on the board.
Another Notre Dame player down. I think it's Jamie Ryan. Offensive lineman in on that field goal team. Already Notre Dame has lost Justin Tuck earlier.
Bob and Brad, just wanted to remind you guys and everybody at home, Notre Dame policy with regard to injuries is that they do not give out injury information. Policy they had for quite some time, a policy that Coach Willingham brought with him from Stanford. So we will not be able to give you any direct information with regard to the injuries we've seen on the Notre Dame sideline.
It's too bad because of the privacy situation. We try not to speculate. Sometimes you can pretty much tell what hurts on a player, but I still get asked by my friends constantly, why don't you guys give us the injury information? We just can't do it. That's the way it is. So Jamie goes off. And hopefully he'll be able to rejoin the Notre Dame lineup the next time they have a kick. And we've got a kick coming up. Scoring drive, 42 yards and 8 plays. And as Bob said, a big one for them because they first of all failed on a 4th-and-1 and they didn't want to come away with no points on that one, and they get the 50-yard field goal with plenty to spare. And now Fitzpatrick's got it teed up, set to kick away to Steve Gregory and Johnny Moran. It's Gregory from the 1. With the return set up to the left side, he got across the 20, and that is all. Nice job by Notre Dame. And the special teams are BCS standings presented by Allstate. There's how tight it is, 1.53. That's what Bob was talking about earlier.
LSU is 1.53 behind USC. And, you know, we're going to have the number one and number two teams on a little bit later. USC is playing after our game out in Los Angeles against Oregon State, and in Oklahoma tonight. Probably has a tougher game going up against Kansas State.
This game, the bearing, and John and Craig and Terry talked about it before the game. We touched on it. If Notre Dame wins this, it helps USC's strength of schedule. A loss here would help LSU. So we know we got a lot of fans in Baton Rouge, or maybe the fans that went to Atlanta for the SEC championship tonight, wherever you might be watching. We know there's some fans out there that normally wouldn't be cheering for either one of these teams who are today.
That is for sure.
Not only that, Hawaii's even got an impact. They play later tonight against Boise State, and that game would strengthen USC's schedule if Hawaii was to win that game. So
let's see.
It's a trickle-down effect.
You got Southern California fans pulling for Notre Dame.
It doesn't seem right, does it? Swanee knows that.
Just one day, though.
Yeah, just one day.
Yeah. Even that's painful.
It is. I knew it was for you, Swanee. Second down and 9. Anderson comes up throwing out to Morant. Looks like he's got a first down as he landed right on our yellow line or very close to it. And we might have to take a look at this one. Morant, the big target wide receiver. A senior, 6'4", about 225 pounds.
There he is, just coming off the line of scrimmage. One of the things they wanted to do to him is get up in his face and jam him at the line of scrimmage. He's a big, tall drink of water, and they feel like if they could get into him and jam him, they could disrupt his route.
He didn't get the spot that he was hoping for, that's for sure. So it's still third down, less than a yard. And the first quarter comes to a close before that third down can happen. We played one at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. Interception by Smith, set up a touchdown. They've swapped field goals. The end of one, it's 10-3. Our presentation of college football continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
The Road to the BCS is presented by Russell Athletic. On November 22nd, Ohio State marched into Michigan's Big House for the 100th meeting between these two Big Ten rivals. Highlighted by two John Navarre to Braylon Edwards TD passes and 154 yards rushing by Chris Perry, including a TD. The Wolverine offense was dominant on their way to the 35-21 victory.
They set up in the eye on this, the last play of the game. And here's the snap. Hand off to the tailback. Peterson tries the right side. Wow, what a hit. But he stays on his feet and he's broken to the outside and it's wide open. Touchdown. Give him a touchdown.
Client on trial for murder.
Can't we all just get along?
A lawyer's tactics could go too far.
You trying to get me convicted?
An all-new practice, ABC Sunday.
Everyone comes to play on Monday night.
Rams, Browns, Monday night on ABC.
They changed the McNuggets, you know.
Why change with nuggets?
Who changed the McNuggets?
I love McNuggets.
Nuggets don't need to be changed.
If you're gonna change something, change broccoli.
Change is good.
McDonald's new chicken McNuggets are now made with white meat. Come on in. You'll love the change.
I'm loving it.
Meteorologist Richard McCullough's weather forecast tonight on News Source 13.
Sophomore offensive lineman Jamie Ryan heading to the locker room with an ice bag on his right knee. He was injured earlier on that successful Notre Dame field goal. We start the second quarter. Third down and inches for Syracuse. R.J. Anderson throws on third and short and overshot his intended receiver, Jared Jones. So they're going for a big play there when all they needed was a couple inches for a first down.
You should never misconnect on that one. You got the quarterback outside. The defense is way fooled by the fake. You got a receiver on a defensive back one-on-one. You got to make connections there.
Fourth down and inches. There's the most completion single season. Pass Marvin Graves earlier in the first quarter. It's actually second down. Now, where that first down came from, I'm sorry, I don't know. But it's second down and 10 is the way they have it on the chains. Apparently, during the timeout, did they change the ruling on whether or not Morant had the first down? They had it third down until we went to the break. How do you like that one? That's a little twist for us.
There's a hoax.
Yeah, the hoax going on. Paul Pasqualoni in his 13th year, second winning as coach ever in Syracuse history with 100 victories, but he's been stuck on 100 for a month. He'd like to move it to 101 here today. Third down at 4. And the pass out the flat to Reyes to the blocker in front. And Walter's got the first down. Across the 45, out near the 47.
It's a nice play. They had a little slip screen. Look downfield. The receivers weren't open. Short routes. Pull a lineman just in case you dump it to Reyes and pick up the first down. Now you're going to see a lineman come out here with him late. Right there in front of him. That's the center, Romeo. Reyes is the second leading running back receiver in the conference. He caught 35 coming into the ballgame.
So first down at the 47. This first down they tell us about. And across midfield, Reyes on the ground picks up 4. Walter Reyes, we talked about how good he is and how smooth he is. Let's take a look at some of his other qualities. First of all, he's a guy that likes to lift weights. He's strong. Explosive speed. I didn't even see him there. That looked like a roadrunner. And you love this one.
Greek. I love it. He got good hands. You saw.
Got like the pillow there. Soft hands.
He is strong. He's a weightlifter with soft hands.
Nice combination. Anderson. Oh, did he get tagged? He was going to go long. And instead he went down. And he's still down. Loss of five. Bible came in from the secondary on a play that looked like it had great possibilities for Syracuse, and by the time he finally pulled up the throw, he got one right in the chops.
Little play action fake. Now he's going to throw deep. Steps around. Now you need to throw right there. Gets hit once, twice.
He wishes he'd have thrown it.
Gone down the first time.
Now it's third down and long. Third and 11. Syracuse 35% of the season on their third down conversions. Three wide receivers. Rashard Williams is in the slot. Anderson pressured again, and he hits one of his linemen. That's going to draw a flag. Yeah. Finally, it flies in. So the pressure of Notre Dame, even without Justin Tuck in there, defensive end, they're getting good heat right now on the quarterback. And illegally hit Nick Romeo, his center. Not sure what could take this long in the discussion. That's a penalty no matter how you slice it.
There's going to be no foul in the play. There's no illegal touching. He did not intentionally try to catch the ball. Fourth down.
Oh boy.
Didn't try to catch it, but he did hit an offensive lineman, and that doesn't matter.
It shouldn't.
Watch the defensive line right in here. That's Campbell, number 60. Gets in the pocket. Oh, he did reach out.
He
for
did
it.
Touch it.
He did reach out to catch it.
Well,
now the referee was standing right there, but he's not looking at that offensive line. He's looking at the quarterback only to protect him.
He's only got about seven other guys in stripes that could help him out. It's the same crew that changed a third down and inches to a first down during the end of the first quarter. I think they missed another one.
It's not a big foul though.
They're going to lose the ball either way.
They're going to lose it anyway.
Timeout. I think it's time for everybody to gather their thoughts down there on the field. It's 10-3.
And I don't even have that insurance.
What insurance, Santa?
The one that pays you cash if you're hurt and can't work.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Don't just give a gift.
Give the good life. This is the year to create the ultimate workshop, and Sears is the place to do it.
Tools make the man.
Stores my tools, charges my batteries. I love it.
I've never seen this anywhere but Sears.
A carbide tip blade and a 5,000 RPM motor. That's the good life.
The big tool sale at Sears. Get great savings on top brands like this Craftsman Project Center for just $99.99.
Give the good life.
No, knee. This is it.
Only Tostitos scoops have the bite-sized bowl-shaped design that's perfect for dipping and dunking every time. So however you like to dip, there's only one dip lover's chip.
I own this court.
Yeah. No, I really own this court. You guys gotta go.
Tostitos scoops, the dip lover's chip.
Tuesday, 10, 9 Central.
Notre Dame now just outside its own 19-yard line, trailing by a touchdown. Takes over offensively. Brady Quinn, play action. Wants to go deep and does. Got a man open. Stolo's got it. Down to the 46-yard line. Anthony Smith, the guy that made the tackle, but Stovall had several steps on the Syracuse secondary.
Well, they want to throw deep on the secondary. As we mentioned, the receiver on this side is going to come all the way across the field. Now, it takes time when you do this. A little play action might help you. The receiver at the bottom of the screen clears it out. And then the crossing receiver just comes across, and that's well designed. Could have thrown it down the field a little bit more, maybe had a bigger play.
Here's a stretch play to Jones. He tries to get in the corner on the outside and does. Takes a couple of tacklers out of bounds, including Diamond Ferry with him. But probably the best game of the day for Julius, a pickup of six on the sweep. Julius Jones coming in 1,229 yards, so he has an opportunity for the single season rushing mark set by Vegas Ferguson back in 79. And the coaches and players alike honestly told us this week it's a very big goal for this offense to achieve that. They're not gonna pull him back if he has a big day goal, and they want him to get that record. Only 15 yards for him so far today. And here he goes, finally breaking one. Julius Jones inside the 20, all the way down to the 12-yard line. 26 yards on the pickup. Well, right on cue for Julius.
There's the offensive line. There's going to be two guys, Molinaro and Lavor, the left guard and the left tackle, going to pull and come to the right side. Steps to the left. Now he finds the hole. It's a little late in coming, but Lavor, 73, finds his way through it, and Jones does the rest.
Well, the big fellas open a hole for him. They'll try to open another one. And he lost the ball, and Syracuse has it. Steve Gregory with a fumble recover. Notre Dame had it going their way and looked like they were going to tie the game up, but Jones put it on the carpet. I think Scanlon, the middle linebacker, is the guy that caused it. 57 coming into your picture. Nope.
No, it's
going to be Ferrara. Josh Thomas or Ferrara. Ferrara.
It's Ferrara.
There it is.
Yeah. Yeah, 93, that's Ferrara, fifth-year senior. And they all want to pick it up and score with it.
So that's Syracuse has got it back.
Second turnover today already for Notre Dame.
Nice play action by Anderson. Wants to go deep now. Comes back across the middle of Johnny Moran. Out of bounds at the 41-yard line. First down, Syracuse.
It's a very similar route that Notre Dame just ran on that big play that they hit going the other way. The receiver on the right side crosses all the way over to the left. It's going to start at the quarterback's right side, going to go in a little bit. The receiver's leaving because it's a zone coverage. And then Ellick picks him up.
And out to the 41. So first down for the Orangemen following the fumble recovery. The toss now to Reyes. Cuts it back up inside. Got about three. Bible from the secondary made the hit. And Bible still down after making that hit.
Brad and Bob, you know, Johnny Morant, when we watch him catch that last play, that is the best kind of pattern for him, a tall, long strider as a wide receiver. I'm watching him during the course of the day at practice. He's not the best when it comes to those sharp breaks when you got to cut 90 degrees in at full speed. What Morant can do is angle at top speed very well, so the crossing routes will be a strong suit for him.
Yeah, that's for sure. Second down and seven. He's to the bottom of your screen right now. Anderson wants to go across the middle, though, and does. Garrett Jones whipped around by Watson, the middle linebacker, and it'll bring up third down and about four. Closing in on 10 minutes remaining in the half. Our Aflac trivia question this week: who is the NFL's all-time leading scorer? All right, we'll have the answer a little bit later on.
Oh, wait a minute, guys. Because I have the league, we're now leaving college to go to the NFL.
It's all tied together.
Trying to trick me?
Nope. It's all tied together.
Must be tied together. Look out.
Anderson got rid of it. And hit as he threw by Darrell Campbell. And it's incomplete. The Orangemen will have to give it up.
Watch at the top up here, the top left of your screen. That's the defensive back. Richardson, is it? Yeah, Richardson, number 30. He was out there faking like he was covering the close receiver. Whenever you're that close, you got a quarterback, you got to look over and make sure he doesn't blitz.
So, punting team out. Carney to kick for Syracuse. McKnight back deep for Notre Dame.
Great,
wow, nice punt.
Yeah.
Maybe too good. That almost hit the end zone on the fly. He got all of that, baby. 53-yard punt. Touchback. Notre Dame will have it at the 20 when we return. 9:36 remaining first half. Syracuse in front.
Harmon will try to squib it, and he does. The Bears have to get out of bounds. Rogers along the sideline. Another one. They're still in deep trouble at midfield. They tried to do a couple of... The ball is still loose as they get it to Rogers. They give it back now to the 30. They're down to the 20. Oh, the band is out on the field. He's going to go into the end zone. He's going into the end zone. Will it count? The Bears have scored. I have never, never seen anything like it.
I went to pick up her uncle. She said he was short, white hat.
Short?
Come on, Uncle Pillsbury Doughboy?
I never met him.
I should have sent you a picture, but that camera phone thing's just too complicated.
Here, Sprint made Picture Mail right. It's easy to take and send pictures anywhere on their complete wireless network because they built it from the ground up.
Thanks.
May I?
Everyone else does.
Now get two PCS Vision picture phones for $149.98. PCS from Sprint.
I went from Phoenix, Arizona, all the way to Tacoma, Philadelphia, Atlanta, LA, Northern California, where the girls are warm, so I could hear my sweet baby say.
Wrangler 5-star premium quality denim. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Pontiac, official performance machines of the NCAA. Sprint, one sprint, many solutions. And Pacific Life, offering insurance, annuities, and investments. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. It's snowing outside, a nice toasty 68 in here, and it's 10-3. Syracuse in front. They got an early interception. That led to the only touchdown we've had in the ballgame so far. Notre Dame's got it back now, working from its own 20-yard line. Comes a blitz. Quinn, nice play fake. Scanlon's close to him, but he airs it out for Shelton. Oh, man! They're not going to give it to him, but did he put an effort out there?
Shelton's the one that caught the long pass last week at Stanford. He's only caught two balls on the year and one for that touchdown last week.
Watch this effort.
The last two first downs, Notre Dame has thrown the ball deep, play action deep.
I think you're going to see that even though he does catch the back end of the ball, then it's cradled after it hits the turf.
That's a good call by the field judge.
What an effort, though, huh?
I like the call. First down, throwing deep. Syracuse is stacked up to stop the Notre Dame run, and the deep passing is there. They just have to take advantage of it.
Now McKnight and Holiday are the receivers. They'll keep it on the ground. And boy, I tell you what, Julius Jones had both arms wrapped around that ball as soon as he touched it, but he didn't get much. And Scanlon, the senior, playing his final game in here, the leading tackler, and I said earlier, he's fired up. He's a good one. Academic, first-team All-American again, playing his last game. Wants to be an orthopedic surgeon. I would not let this dude operate on me. I'm sorry.
Now, come on. You take the cap off. You give him a shave, and you get a smile on his face.
No, not with those knuckles.
Yeah.
Third down and long.
He's operating on some offenses this year.
Yes, he is. Quinn running out of time, and down he goes. Ferrara, who made the big play to force the fumble, now has a sack to add to it.
Well, the strength of this defense is that defensive line, Gashlin and Ferreira in particular, the two inside tackles. You can't take all day to throw that. Like I said, Notre Dame is throwing the ball deep, and that takes some time to wait in the pocket.
Fitzpatrick to punt now. Notre Dame's had some punt problems this year. getting some blocks, and he's in his own end zone. Syracuse, a great punt blocking squad over the years. They got close to him, but he got off the dandy. Clayton all the way back at the 40. And the freshman coming the other way. He stopped abruptly at the 47-yard line.
You see the way he catches that ball in his hand?
Yeah.
He just reaches up and just plucks it.
15-yard return of a 48-yard kick.
Bob, I used to catch punts for a long time with the Steelers and at USC. I'd never call them like this. And one day in practice, Chuck Noll came to me and said, Lynn, when the ball comes in, put your hands up, catch it like that. He goes, let me show you how. He puts his hand up, the ball came to him, Chuck broke his pinky. I've never tried it again.
I thought you were going to say broke his nose.
Yeah.
That's good.
You got to have good hand-eye coordination
to do that. Good field position now for Syracuse at the Irish 47. Reyes, and he's dropped for a loss. Aviamiri, the freshman, he's going to be a dandy too. 6'5", 245.
And Notre Dame has three true freshmen starting, two of them in the offensive and defensive lines. Aviamiri and Harris, and then Brady Quinn at the quarterback position. So these guys are awfully good players that have been forced in or earned their way into the starting lineups.
Second and 14 now. It's a four receiver group for Anderson. Wants to throw a screen. He lobbed it. Watson. Now it comes back and it's incomplete.
That's not the way you want to throw a screen.
No,
pass.
No.
Oh, boy.
He lobbed that baby. Jim Boeheim wouldn't even like that lob. Watch this. He almost lobbed it right to the middle linebacker.
No. This is too much. Watson, the middle linebacker, gets in there and knocks it away, almost knocks it back to one of the linemen to catch it. That is too high, and that ball stays in the air too long, and Watson was there anyway, so there was a fox in the hen house. You don't do that.
Third down and 14. Anderson back to throw again, getting pressured. Got away from it, going long. Throwing into coverage. It's intercepted.
Just like a punt. He just threw it up. The defense had more of a chance of catching that one. And Burrell pulled it down.
So Burrell with the interception at the 5. And Notre Dame will take over there when we come back. 7:07 remaining first half.
It passes better than a West Coast offense. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
The persistence of 135 years of experience. The performance that has enabled us to work with more than half the Fortune 500. The strength of one of the largest financial services companies in America. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
Can't taste my beer. I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer!
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer! I can't taste my beer!
Next time, try the light beer that actually tastes like beer. Great tasting, less filling, Miller Lite. Good call. Blitz, every chance you get. Pontiac Vibe. Fuel for the soul.
Tiger Woods, Mike Weir, British Open champ Ben Curtis, and TJ Singh had a field of 16 of the best. Target World Challenge presented by Williams next Saturday on ABC.
Notre Dame now to work from the 6-yard line following the interception by Burrell. I know Quentin likes that fourth interception, but if he looks back on it, the whole scheme of things, the punt would have probably been better. He had better field position.
Just drop it. Their average field position has not been very good.
On the ground, Grant dropped at the 1-yard line.
Now this defensive line for Syracuse is getting after it.
Ferrara is fired up. He had a sack last time. And now another tackle for loss. Let's check in with Swanee.
Well, guys, Farrar knew he was going to be under some pressure this year. He dropped down to his weight. He was well over 300 pounds. Knew he'd have to be in a lot this year because it was a weak defensive line, didn't have a lot of depth, and he was unbelievable. He's one of the strongest guys on this football team. He actually bench presses 535 and did a hand clean three times at 402 pounds.
Yeah, he's a strong guy. Chris Ripon, offensive coordinator, calls him our enforcer. Notre Dame in danger here now as Jones tries to bring it out of the end zone. Got out across the two. That's about it. So they're still going to be in a precarious spot here. And the last man up, Lavore, trying to lead the way. Julius Jones today struggling on the ground. Had one nice run, but only 42 yards on 13 carries. They'll be lining everybody up in that end zone again, and it's getting noisy down there. The Orange fans making some noise in the Carrier Dome.
With the Syracuse players all week, R.J. Anderson and the rest of them asking the fans of to come out and cheer them on, win this last ball game.
They're going to take a timeout. Scanlon called timeout for the Syracuse defense. They're trying to come up with a big play with Notre Dame deep in its own territory.
Zoom, zoom, zoom. Shoot you right down. Off of your feet.
Olympus brings you the incredible power of a 10x optical zoom. Get 10 times closer. Now that's a powerful zoom.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
The Ultra Zoom from Olympus. Designed to do more.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
Introducing the Bowflex Ultimate. Quite possibly the best home fitness machine ever made. Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. Own the new Bowflex Ultimate with no money down and monthly payments lower than many health club dues. Call and ask for a free video or DVD or visit us on the web today. The new Bowflex for ultimate results.
There's only one woman in the world. This Christmas, celebrate her. A diamond is forever.
Sister Virginia, she's saying a little prayer there for the defense.
She's not praying for Notre Dame.
No. She's praying for
diehard Orangemen fan, that's for sure.
Third and long, will Quinn throw from his own end zone? Yes. Got rid of it. Got a man open in Shelton. Just overshot it. And he aired it out and he paid the price, but it's incomplete, and now it's a very uncomfortable spot to punt from.
Well, you're right. Punting from the back of your end zone is not fun, but look at the pressure. Little play action, that helps the pass protection, but you got to get around and throw it. Ferrara is on him again.
Ferrara's having a game, isn't he? Fitzpatrick backed up to his own end line. Dangerous spot for DJ, and he knows it. He got the kick away. Not that much pressure. Marcus Clayton fields it again. His hands out in front of him. Broke one tackle and another. But he only got about 5 yards. Another flag flies in. We're probably going to have an illegal block on the return. A 42-yard kick out of deep in his own end zone and a 5-yard return. And they're going to back that up a little bit more, probably. There's the call by Jim Lapatina, so they'll walk this back near midfield. There's a shot outside the Carrier Dome, still snowing out there. Our Aflac trivia question we asked you a little while ago. We gave you some time to think about it. Who's the NFL's all-time leading scorer? Can I guess this week?
You can guess.
I'll say Gary Anderson, who played here and kicked and is still kicking.
Well, Larry Zonka, a teammate of mine, played here, and I know it's not him. He scored a few points, but I like Gary Anderson.
Swanee?
Well, I played with Gary Anderson, and I know how he loves to kick, although unfortunately for Gary, he didn't have the Carrier Dome, I don't think, when he was here. But I'd go with Gary.
We'll give you the answer right after R.J. Anderson's pass on the bootleg. And lobbed it down the sideline for his tight end, and he made the catch. Lenny Cusumano, that's a heck of a grab.
Especially since you've only caught four passes all year long.
That's right.
Cusumano is a blocking tight end. He says, give me a little of that sugar. He waited outside the pocket, then he made it wobble a little bit so it may be easier for him to catch.
Career long reception of 30 yards for a happy tight end. Another one of the seniors.
That was just good coverage downfield, but because the quarterback Anderson was outside the pocket, he had a lot of time to throw it.
So first down, Syracuse now threatening again at the Notre Dame 22-yard line. Anderson option, late pitch to Reyes. Notre Dame stretches it out, but he gets his balance, puts his hand down, and gets all the way down to the 15-yard line. Nice run. We asked the NFL's all-time leading scorer why it had anything to do with this game. It had something to do with this game. He kicked here. And at 22 NFL seasons, over 2,300 points. Gary Anderson, former Orangeman. And it looks like it's all going to come down to the bowl game. Lynn's got the lead.
No. I think we ought to move him back to 7.
Why?
Well, just general principle.
excuse me, Bob.
We make up the rules as we go along. Jared Jones being helped off. He was out there trying to block on that play.
He's their starting wide receiver. He's playing because of the injury to Riddle. Jamal Riddle was their starter at that position coming back, and he missed out in the summer school, didn't get his grades properly, and is not academically eligible. So Jones had been filling in very nicely.
So that means Fontenette's going to get a lot more time, and he's in there right now, right at the bottom of your screen.
He's a tall drink of water, too.
He's going to go in motion back toward the ball. Anderson to throw the other way, and it's complete. Johnny Morant's got a first down, and it's first and goal, Syracuse. At the conclusion of our game today, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. So first and goal, Syracuse, trying to add to its touchdown lead here in the final 4:40. Ty Willingham trying to urge on his Notre Dame defense.
The defense lost one of their better players, Justin Tuck. We showed you in the first quarter he had a knee injury. They've taken him into the locker room, and I don't think he's going to be back today.
The option, straight ahead it goes for about a yard, maybe a little bit more. Courtney Watson made the tackle on the fullback Belton. We were talking about Thump Belton. He's had a good block and a nice reception in this game. One of the senior captains out of Charlotte, North Carolina. His real name is not Thump, but that's what everybody calls him. He's Keith Belton. He can put a thump on you. Watson, the leader of that Notre Dame defense, over 100 tackles coming in. Those two have met several times today already.
Uh-huh.
Second and goal. Play action. Have to throw in a hurry. Intercepted. Touchback Notre Dame. Vontaze Duff with the pick this time, and that's a big one.
And it's tied in wide open and overthrew him by quite a bit.
So interceptions now by Burrell and Vontaze Duff. This is Duff's second of the year.
It's going to be a play action fake. He's going to come out here. The tight end is going to be right in this area and going to be wide open. Play action fake. Rolls the other way. Now he's trying to get it right here. There is a receiver over here also, but the tight end is the one that's wide open, and he overthrows it so much that Duff on the outside intercepts it.
Big interception there for Notre Dame. So they take over. They squelch the scoring drive. Get it back at the 20. Now going to work with Ryan Grant. Grant. And he gets about 9. Ball comes loose at the end of the play, and it already been whistled down. Ellen Pruitt, the guy that made the tackle. So it's going to be a second down and about a yard to go. Paul Pasqualoni, we mentioned 100 wins here at Syracuse in his 13th season. Last year, Syracuse went 4-8, and they finished 2-5 in the Big East, and they have that same record in the Big East this year. and trying to even their mark at 6-6 if they can beat the Fighting Irish here today. Just over 3 minutes remaining first half. Second down in the yard for Notre Dame. Quinn play action, quickly throws, complete. Josh Smith out of the backfield. Smith still going forward. He's out to the 43, almost the 44-yard line. A pickup of 15 and a first down. Our Pacific Life game summary. Notre Dame's done some good things, but some things have gone awry. That was on early in the quarter. The interception led to a touchdown. Then they were stopped on fourth down and a yard. And then Jones fumbled when hit by Ferrara. That turned it back over to Syracuse. That one didn't do any damage. The Orangemen had to punt, but every time they seem to get something going offensively, and they've done it to the tune of 165 yards, something goes wrong for them. They've got it working again. Trying to tie this game up at halftime. Oh, whoa, what a collision. Kelvin Smith, the outside linebacker, said hello to Ryan Grant.
Bob and Brad, just to give you a quick update, Jared Jones, number 12, has a left ankle sprain. They're checking it right now. He's still hobbling over on the sideline.
All right, Swanee, thank you. There's the timeout situation remaining as we approach 2 minutes left in the quarter. And a second down and nine coming up for Notre Dame. Jones back in there at the tailback spot. McKnight now trots over in motion. And Quinn back to throw, goes out. This one worked once, and might as well try it again. Josh Schmidt out of the backfield. He's got another first down as we check in with John in New York.
Alongside of Terry and Craig, coming up on the Capital One Halftime Show, we'll look at today's other two games that are going to affect the national championship picture.
Yeah, and we'll talk about Pete Carroll. They say he's a rah-rah coach for Southern California. He is, and they're glad he is.
Hey, man, all the players are buying into it. Plus the fact that Big 12 championship game you're talking about, Oklahoma's a great football team, but Kansas State has the ability to win. It's going to be competitive.
It's all coming up on the Capital One Halftime Show. Back to you guys.
All right, fellas, see you in about a minute, 25 seconds. Quinn back to throw again over the middle. This one's complete. Nice job by McKnight. He's got another first down. That'll stop the clock. They'll move the chains and down to the 34-yard line.
I think for Kansas State to stay in that ball game tonight, L. Roberson has got to have a big night.
Right.
Running and throwing the football. I mean, just the unpredictability of someone at that position can keep a team in a game, and Oklahoma is awfully good.
Quinn out of the shotgun throws, and he had a man wide open, and he got too much on it. Omar Jenkins could have had another first down. Now coming up next, game two of our triple header. The guys were talking about this. Number two USC needs a win over Oregon State to earn a spot in the national championship game. And tonight at 8 Eastern, it is undefeated top-ranked Oklahoma to take on Kansas State in the Dr. Pepper Big 12 championship. Tell you what, as good as USC is, and we saw them a couple of weeks ago against UCLA, and they dominated that game, they better not forget that they got a date this afternoon, too. That's not going to be an easy one, I don't think.
Well, yeah, but it's been a while since Oregon State's won down there in Los Angeles.
It's been down in the 60s, but yeah, they're not a bad football team, though.
No, they're not. But 18 games in a row they've lost there.
You hate those law of averages.
That's true.
Penalty marker on the play.
There's two ways to look at everything, isn't
it? Well, everybody's so concerned about LSU and USC, and if somebody would leapfrog, I don't think LSU better forget about Georgia tonight in Atlanta either. Illegal procedure.
You know, this is the sixth year of the BCS, and in two of the 5 years of the BCS, it's come down to the last weekend, this yep. day here, to decide who is going to play in the championship game.
You always say, let's play them all, then we'll figure it out.
Yeah,
we still got some playing to
play
do.
Play all the games.
So the penalty walks it back to the 39-yard line.
You know, this, like I said, the sixth year, the champion of those 5 years, the BCS has been undefeated every year. We've had an undefeated national champion the last 6 years and eight of the last nine. There's only one undefeated team left this year.
Yep.
And I think they're going to be pretty hard to beat.
I do, too. That much we all agree on. At the 39, second and 15. Here comes a blitz on Quinn. He's flushed by Stanley. Got rid of it and almost completed it. Omar Jenkins, the intended receiver. So it's going to be third down and long.
Here it is right here in the yellow. In 98, And then again in 01, the final two teams in the championship game weren't set until the last day.
That's the way it ought to be.
Now, last year in 02, it was settled way ahead of time. Miami and Ohio State, they won their games, and nobody changed. But we got a couple more games to play before the season's over.
You don't want to be wearing those outfits outside at Syracuse today. Here they come again. Down goes Quinn again.
This defensive line is manhandling that offensive line now.
That time it was Gashlin, another senior. He and Ferrara are raising some havoc in there.
You're right. The two tackles, Gashlin right here and Ferrara next to him, are just causing havoc. He goes around. What is that, Stevenson? No, it's Mitchell, number 69.
What basically has happened now in the last three plays, a penalty, and Quinn incomplete and then being sacked, it took them out of field goal range. They're way back at the 49
now. Yeah.
These two coaches trying to win their sixth game of the season. How about our coaching performance of the year, in our opinion? We all give it to this guy.
I mean, he's had the best team, but time after time, we go out there, every time we're there, we see it.
That's some of our other opinions. Bob Stoops will probably be the coach of the year, but I always like what Kirk Ferentz does at Iowa, what Mark Richt's done at Georgia.
How about Saban? Nick Saban.
Swanee did the diplomatic thing there. He put Pete and Nick both. That way it didn't look like he was favoring USC.
Well, I think both guys did a tremendous job.
Well, they have.
Of course, when you look at USC, the job that Pete Carroll and Child have done as offensive coordinator, especially with a quarterback who hadn't thrown a pass for him until the season began.
Yep. Well, now it's punting time for Fitzpatrick. He would have had a chance for a long field goal had those last three plays not blown up in Notre Dame's face. Only 22 seconds remaining in the quarter. Clayton waits for the punt. If he gets it off, he does. That's a pretty good kick again. Clayton fields this one. Fair catch at the 16-yard line.
I'm impressed with Paul Pasqualoni's job of getting his players ready to play. They've lost three games. The last game of the year, they could have come in and just kind of wrote it off. But they're playing this like a bowl game,
they
like
really
he
are.
Wanted them to.
That's what he told us. He said, hey, it's Notre Dame. It's 1 o'clock. It's the only game on right now. It's national TV. It's our bowl game. He admitted it. And they're playing like it. Anderson will just take a knee. And that will end things in the first half. A successful first half for Syracuse. Hard-hitting defense by Syracuse as we check in with Swanee.
Coach, you told us earlier that you wanted to put the game in the hands of the young quarterback, but are you surprised he's trying to throw so deep when he's throwing the football?
Well, yeah, I am. We anticipated that they would go after us deep. I think our guys are holding up, you know, fairly well against the deep ball. A few of them have been close, but it doesn't surprise me that he's going deep.
Christian Ferraro has been playing great for you in the second half, as well as your defensive line. What kind of flexibility does that play give you in terms of how you handle another?
Well, it gives us a lot of flexibility. We're doing well with a four-man rush. We got them one time with a three-man rush. And when you can rush four and rush three and play maximum coverage, I think it helps you quite a bit.
Tough football game. We'll look forward to
seeing
you
very much.
Half.
Thank you.
Brett?
All right, guys. It's halftime at the Carrier Dome. 10-3. Syracuse fans are happy. Let's send it back to Times Square Stadium. John Terry and Craig, fellas.
All right, Brad, thanks a lot. We saw it last week with Frank Solich, and the talk is that Paul Pasqualoni is on his way out as coach of Syracuse. It's ridiculous. He has done a tremendous job, coach.
I'll follow up with you. He has done a heck of a job. The grass isn't always greener in the other pasture, and some of these programs have to accept parities here. It's a real deal. These smaller conference schools, they're out there competing now, and your school won't do the same year in and year out that it maybe did in the past.
Yeah, but college football, it's about what have you done for me lately, and if he has a losing game here, that's two losing seasons in a row. Nobody made him take over $1 million for a salary. College coaches, when they get $1 million, they got to expect to go if they don't win right away.
What have you done for me lately, by the way?
I've stood by your side.
All right, we'll stick around. We'll preview the other games coming up in the Capital One Halftime Show after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Mr. Goodwrench, who is this one and only GM expert? I gotta find this guy.
You're Mr. Goodwrench.
Yep.
Which means you use genuine GM parts.
Well, actually, we all do.
Now you're just trying to throw me.
Mr. Goodwrench had over 1 million hours of GM training last year?
That's right.
Doesn't leave much time for Mrs. Goodwrench now, does it?
Find Mr. Goodwrench at over 7,000 GM dealerships nationwide.
If Mr. Goodwrench were a tool, what kind of tool would he be?
A wrench?
Ooh, sorry. Miter saw is what we were looking for. Miter saw.
Why don't you take a picture? It'll last longer.
You don't have a camera.
You ain't got no camera. Nobody gonna believe you because you ain't got no camera.
Oh, are you gonna call your mom? Hey, Mom, I'm talking to a celeb.
Oh.
With Singular, take a picture, add a voice message.
You ain't got no camera.
Copy all your friends, and you're only charged once. Plus, you get great deals on camera phones.
Want to play a fun game of chase?
Picture, voice, and text. Another reason Singular fits you best.
To qualify for a home on a teacher's income sometimes is difficult. Teacher Flex was created by Bank of America to allow teachers to move into cities and towns that need teachers.
I purchased my home at age 24, which is incredible.
We can do zero down, and they're going to help us cover all the closing costs.
Being able to buy my first house, it's really special.
I am Yvonne Batterton, and I'm proud to be part of Bank of America.
Bank of America, they helped us, you know, get the loan and become part of that community.
Really empowered me to take another bold step in my life.
We help connect people. We make it as easy as possible.
I've kind of got my foot in the door. Now I can take what I've learned from that and I can help other people.
It gives me a good foundation in order to give them that hope, those dreams that can come alive for them.
You really feel like you're a part of their life, not just their teacher, because you see them all over the place.
People know that I'm the teacher on the block.
I can do this 24 hours a day.
Bank of America, higher standards.
You're watching ABC.
Falling down, and your car is out of whack. The trailer hitch is falling off, and your shocks have all relaxed. Just come on down to Call Muffler. The service can't be beat. Come on down to Call Muffler and give your car a treat.
There's a Call Muffler brake shop near you.
Plan your day with an accurate weather forecast. Turn to 13, the Weather Authority.
The Capital One Halftime Show, brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet? From Times Square in New York, John Saunders, Terry Bowden, and Craig James.
Plenty of snow here in Times Square in New York City, but we are told in Kansas City it will just be cold and windy for the Big 12 championship game. John Saunders, Terry Bowden, and Craig James. As we look towards that game, Oklahoma's been undefeated the entire season. One more step to get to the Nokia Sugar Bowl. For a preview, Brent Musburger and Gary Danielson.
Well, John, if weather is the great equalizer, then Kansas State is going to love it because, Gary, it's going to be cold, windy, no snow in the forecast. Oklahoma, clearly the number one team in the nation. Gary, can Kansas State stick with the Sooners?
I think they can, Brent. I really don't believe there's anything as an unbeatable team, but Oklahoma, if you don't play your best game, will crush you. Kansas State must first take care of themselves, but they have the type of team with great balance on offense, running the ball inside and outside, throwing the ball deep and short, and power up front that could make it a game.
Well, what's very interesting for the Sooners is that if they win this game and then down in New Orleans, they will be compared with the greatest ever.
Brent, absolutely. And we compare them to the 95 Nebraska team. They hold up very well. Look at the bottom, scoring 50-plus points. They've done it seven times. And, Craig James, I'll give you the credit. You sat here 3 or 4 weeks ago and said if they make that run and go all the way to the title undefeated, they are one of the best teams in the history of college football.
Yeah, and you know what? You set to say one of the best. You don't ever say they're the best because that's unfair to some of the other programs. But considered in that grouping, a small grouping, they would. When you look at points allowed, very important you look at that because if you have a great defense is what makes a great football team. And their offense is good because of the defense.
Well, they're great offense to lead the nation in scoring offense and then lead the nation in defense. That's what makes them a dominant team and maybe one of the best of all time. And that's why, again, Kansas State, I think, has got to hit the ball over top because you don't have 12-play scoring drives against a team like Oklahoma.
I think pretty much everyone agrees that Oklahoma can afford to lose this game and still get to the Nokia Sugar Bowl as the number two team. But right now, they're not sure whether they'll face USC or whether they'll face LSU. LSU has Georgia later on today in the SEC championship game. Remember, in game number one, It was played at LSU, and it was a close one, and this strike was the only difference in the game. The game is in Atlanta, supposedly a neutral site, but I don't think it's going to come out that way.
No, I mean, Georgia, this team played so much better the first time they played. They outplayed LSU, and they missed three field goals and gave up a touchdown in the last minute and a half. This is going to be a great game for Georgia. They can beat this team at LSU.
They may have outplayed them, but they didn't win the ball game. You know, and that's the thing. You know, right now, Georgia's offensive line has to be sitting there getting dressed, thinking about, what have I got to do tonight to keep that LSU front seven out of here? Because that LSU defense, pretty good.
Yep.
All right, LSU and Georgia, USC and Oregon State, Oklahoma and Kansas State. It all remains to be seen who'll be in New Orleans.
On an uncharted island, 12 fierce competitors have gathered for
the Capital One Mascot Island Challenge.
We've separated America's favorite mascots into the polyester and wool blend tribes. First event, Iron Mascot Marathon.
Your vote for the National Mascot of the Year at CapitalOneBowl.com. Tune in the Capital One Bowl to see who wins. Suzuki GSXRs own the racetrack. The first championship was a huge achievement. The second championship was a major coup. The third, an unbelievable feat. The fourth championship is a new record. Matt Mladen is the first four-time Superbike champion. Josh Hayes wins his first Super Stock title. Ben Spies is crowned with his first Formula Extreme Championship. Three more championships, one brand, the Suzuki GSXR. Own the racetrack.
Time, a huge game in the Pac-10. Pete Carroll and the USC Trojans hoping a win over Oregon State will propel them into the Nokia Sugar Bowl for the national championship. John Saunders, Craig James, and Terry Bowden here. And it comes a time in everyone's life when they know it's time to move on, like you did when you left Auburn to come into television for Pete Carroll. He's coached the pros. He knew it when it was time for college.
They told me when it was time to get out of college. But, you know, Pete Carroll chose when he chose to come to college. I don't know how to coach grown men or professional when they how to motivate them, but I do know how to motivate college kids from 18 to 22 years old. You do it with enthusiasm, and Pete Carroll has a ton of it.
There was a time when Trojan football exuded greatness, but the glory days ended in the late 70s. It's hard to believe it's been a quarter of a century since their last national title, but USC is finally back. The man leading the charge, Pete Carroll, a coach whose style was out of place in the NFL because of a certain trait that didn't seem to fit the pro ranks. He was too enthusiastic.
There's this extraordinary seriousness in the NFL that the fun is lost often. All of us are involved in this game because it's fun and we liked it and we loved playing it when we were growing up. And some of that gets hammered out. I was disappointed that that the way I wanted to do it wasn't accepted. And I don't hold any grudge. I don't care. You know, I could care less. All my experiences made me the coach that I am today. I just fit better.
A better fit might be a slight understatement.
It's a great day. It's a great day to be a Trojan.
In just 3 years, Pete Carroll has completely transformed the Trojans. Since starting 2-5, USC has gone 25-4 under Carroll, and maybe one win away from playing for the national title. It's clearly obvious that his kid-like enthusiasm for the game has washed over the program.
We were in full pads, and out of nowhere, he comes flying over the offense like he's a running back. And we're kind of like we're sitting there looking and laughing at each other because we couldn't, our head coach with no pads flying over, you know, the top of a pile.
Coach Carroll is a 52-year-old in a 20-year-old's body. He is so competitive for how old he is that it's that's very funny. I can't think of one person on our team that doesn't just love him.
He came running one day down the hall with his shirt off going crazy. Any head coach who takes his shirt off in a team meeting before the season and gets us fired up, you know he's got a lot of energy and probably didn't want me saying that on camera.
I'm always looking for ways to have fun and to make it different than what they might anticipate it being. I want to have fun in everything we're doing too, you know, so it's maybe more selfish than they realize, you know.
A man whose NFL coaching career was constantly scrutinized and left for dead has found its stride. It is in the halls and on the fields of USC where he has revived a program that some believed might never return to the national stage.
People had said that, you know, USC can never be what it was for whatever reasons. So I'm thrilled to be back in the championship setting. It isn't about money. It isn't about trying to prove something from the past. I could care less about any of that. I'm having too much fun. This is a great place to be. And the continued fun is in continued excellence. And I'm going for it. And the only way I can do that is to do it here.
Yeah, Pete Carroll's also really a rah-rah coach, but there's a lot of X's and O's going on, too. And Craig, the 3 years before he got there, USC was 19-18. Since he left, 26-9 since he's been in there 3 years. That's a pretty good turnaround.
And, you know, he was really true in that. You know, when he says, you know, I don't understand why anybody would say that we can't ever be what USC used to be. Pete Carroll fits there. He said it. You know, sometimes coaches say these things and you're like, okay, really, do you mean it? He means it. The guy really fits in well. He's perfect for the college game. The kids have bought into what he's doing. He raises their athletic ability, that X and an O one that you were talking about. He's good at that, too.
And with all due respect to the folks at Berkeley, though, I'm still trying to figure out how they lost to Cal in overtime, where they'd be undefeated right now, and they'd know they were headed towards the national championship. They need some work. Don't forget, this is what we do know. Florida State out of the ACC, Michigan out of the Big Ten, USC will be in a BCS game. It's just whether or not it will be the championship. Miami out of the Big East, LSU or Georgia from the SEC, Oklahoma or Kansas State from the Big 12. And join us tomorrow at 5:30 Eastern Time, where we'll let you know who is headed to which of these bowls.
The Capital One Mascot Island Challenge.
Tribes, tonight's challenge, a stroll over burning coals.
These coals are 550 degrees, but with positive thinking.
Is that supposed to happen?
Cast your vote for the National Mascot of the Year at CapitalOneBowl.com. Tune in the Capital One Bowl to see who wins.
Life in your wallet!
FIFA Soccer 2004, rated E for everyone. NCAA Football 2004, rated E for everyone. From EA Sports, now on Engage.
The Capital One Halftime Show, brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
From legendary broadcast pioneers to the biggest names in sportscasting today, Syracuse University alumni bring millions of fans the enjoyment of Major League sports. This tradition of talent, diversity, and accomplishment in broadcasting and virtually every field of endeavor is the mark of a Syracuse education. Syracuse University, a signature of success for over 130 years. Sunday, it's one surprise.
You're my best friend. I love you.
After another.
I found a marksman.
An all-new alias. Then, with his client on trial for murder.
Can't we all just get along?
A lawyer's tactics could go too far.
You're trying to get me convicted.
An all-new practice. It all starts at 9, 8 Central, ABC Sunday.
Tomorrow, see how a football team that hadn't won a national championship in over 30 years made believers out of all of us. Relive the magic of Ohio State's march to glory, as well as the Stanley Cup Finals, the NBA Finals, and the Super Bowl. All tomorrow at 3:30 Eastern Time on the Thrill of Victory 2003 ABC Sports Year in Review. We cannot state this enough. This game is important to USC. They need Notre Dame to come back.
Yeah, they need to tell Notre Dame, give the ball to Julius Jones. You've ridden that pony the last 6 weeks. Give him the ball.
Hey, I'm the pony. What are
you doing?
Yeah, I'm the pony over here. It's almost deep analysis. The team who doesn't turn the ball over wins.
Usually works. Second half after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
This Heisman memory is presented by Suzuki Motorcycles. In 1996, Danny Warfel completed his career as the Heisman Trophy winner and arguably the most efficient quarterback in college football history. Warfel ended his Gator career amassing almost 11,000 passing yards and 114 TD passes. In his senior season, Warfel threw 39 touchdowns, leading Florida to a national championship in the Sugar Bowl.
Yes, you're lovely. Never ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight.
Really? Big line at the toll booth. You know those electronic passes?
Yeah.
Used to be one lane, then two, now three.
And you don't have one?
No.
It's the on-demand world.
Huh?
Electronic pass connects to toll booth. Toll booth connects to bank. Bank to your credit card. You come in here with your laptop, click, click, pay your bill through the air. But you don't get it, so you wait in line.
That means something.
And Owen are both dreaming of the same thing for Christmas. Lydia.
This is your lucky day, baby.
New lesson for after a new gym. ABC Tuesday. From the moment the last rose was given.
Will you marry me?
To the bouquet being tossed. At last, the wedding all of America's been waiting for is finally here.
I love you with every ounce of who I am.
At last.
Krista and Ryan's two-hour wedding finale. 9, 8 Central, ABC Wednesday.
Look at something new from Chase Pitkin. Conserve energy and save money with this Intermatic outdoor timer. Set your holiday lights with two on-off programs per day. With Chase Pitkin's sale price and a mail-in rebate, you'll want more than one. Get a first look at Chase Pitkin.
When your muffler's falling down and your car is out of whack, the trailer hitch is falling off and your shocks have all relaxed, come on down to Cole Muffler. The service can't be beat. Come on down to Cole Muffler and give your car a treat.
There's a Cole Muffler brake shop near you.
Last Thanksgiving, about 2 million people tried to deep-fat fry their turkey. 15 succeeded in setting their houses on fire. At Christmas, there was a lot of driving over the river and through the woods and a little bit of skidding on the ice and taking out Grandma's garage door. So while you're celebrating, Allstate will be standing by. Trouble never takes the holiday. Neither should your insurance. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Take a first look at something new from Chase Pitkin. This new combo alarm from Kiddo detects both smoke and carbon monoxide with voice warning.
Fire.
It combines two important types of safety alarms in one unit. Get a first look at Chase Pitkin.
For the scores and more, turn to your local news source.
Back in snowy Syracuse, New York, 10-3. The Orangemen out in front of the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Welcome back, everybody. Brad Nessler, Bob Gracie, and Lynn Swan. Nice and warm inside. Could have been even warmer for Syracuse. They gave one away at the end on that interception.
Yeah, both teams have turned it over twice, and Syracuse has had great field position the entire first half. Notre Dame has had the worst of it.
They have, and Notre Dame had things going. Every time they do something right, they do something wrong.
Not a bad game for the leadoff. You know, we're just leading off for Southern Cal.
That's right.
And Oklahoma, Kansas State, but this is a pretty good football game.
We're the appetizers. We got two more yet to come on our triple header here on ABC today. Fans enjoyed that first half. Great defense, really, by Syracuse. Their interior, those two tackles and Scanlon, the middle linebacker, and, of course, the interception that led to a touchdown. So the defense has done its job. We'll see how the offense will do because they'll touch it first to open the third quarter after D.J. Fitzpatrick kicks away. Steve Gregory at the goal line. Gregory had a fumble recovery in the first half. Is not going to make the 20. Good job by Notre Dame. They bring him down. Jerome Collins drops him at about the 16-yard line. Swanee, what Ty Willingham had to say?
Well, he came out and he first talked about the injury sustained in the first half to his offensive line. Yep. And he said, the second half, what we have to do is find a way to run the football much better in the second half. Our first half activity, he said, was unacceptable. Then when we establish a running game, we can run our play action. We can throw the ball deep down the field. But he was very focused, very serious about trying to establish that run so he could throw the football.
R.J. Anderson in the first half had trouble throwing the football. Inaccurate a couple of times when it could have been big plays. So they'll go back to the ground. Reyes across the 15 out to the 17. We'll give Walter 5 as we take a look at the Pacific Life game summary. Only 36 rushing yards for Syracuse in that first half.
Stats are pretty even. Even the turnovers. Red zone turnovers is something a little different. They both have two turnovers apiece, but each of them have had one. The biggest difference is in the average start at the field starting position. And like I said, Syracuse has had very good field position.
Until this particular instance, and Anderson is smothered trying to throw that pass.
And the referee just made a motion like it was a good release outside the pocket. You can down the football.
So it'll bring up third down. Third down, a long 5 coming up for Syracuse to open up the third quarter.
Let's go back and take a look at that last play.
That last step got him outside that tackle box.
The tackle box, where the tackles line up straight back.
So now, big third down to open the quarter for the Orangemen. Three wide receivers. Morant, the big play man right there in the slot on the left side. Fontenette in motion toward the ball as Anderson drops the throw. And now he's hit and down he goes. So the pressure of Notre Dame's front, much like it was in the second quarter, comes to play here. And Darryl Campbell with the sack.
Well, he had time to throw it. He just didn't get rid of it. R.J. Anderson having some problems in the pocket, not getting rid of it. And sometimes when he does, then he gets it picked off. Hilliard number 50, Campbell 60. They're both putting, there's a huge gaping hole. He should have scooted up and got away from it.
And they blocked the punt. So Notre Dame will have great field position now at about the 30-yard line.
There's a lot of ways to turn around momentum, and Notre Dame comes out at the beginning of the second half and stuffs the Syracuse offense and blocks the punt to give their offense great field position.
Again, is
right up the middle.
Right up the middle.
That's
came.
Mays, number 46. That's the best place to block a punt, right next to the center, either side, because the center is supposed to snap it and then at least get a piece of somebody on his shoulder.
So now let's see if Notre Dame's offense can make it pay off, much like Syracuse did in the first quarter after their interception. That's what led to their touchdown. First down, Irish, the Syracuse 30. Here's a counter delay to Jones. He runs right up his would-be blocker's back and only got a couple. Scandal in the middle linebacker. Another tackle.
Well, you know, Swanee talked. There you see the left guard, Mitchell. Swanee talked to Ty Willingham, and he said the problem was in their offensive line. They've lost two right guards, Stevenson and Ryan. Now Mitchell, number 69, is the third guy they've had at that position.
And he's looking. Second down and 8. Play action. Quinn, the quick throw. This one's worked pretty well for him in the first half. They threw a couple to Schmidt out there. This one's to Powers Neal.
And Notre Dame has not had the benefit of the field position, nor the injuries.
And there's, you see, the wide Jones. Receiver Jared Jones on crutches with that ankle that Swanee reported on.
Trainer came up to me and told me that Jared Jones obviously would not be playing in the second half. I say obviously, with that cast on his left ankle on crutches, you know, he's just down here rooting his team on in the last game of the season.
Yep. A third down coming up for Notre Dame. Third and a long 2. They've got to get to the 20-yard line. Already in field goal range, but they want to try to tie this game up. Quinn will throw on third and short. And not very well, because he again had one of those tackles in his face. Gashlin this time. Here comes a field goal unit.
Well, the right guard, Stevenson, is having all kinds of problems. Take a look right here. Syracuse having all kinds of problems blocking the defensive tackle, either Gashlin or Ferrara.
So the field goal will be a 40-yard try as Fitzpatrick hit from 50 going the other way earlier in the ballgame. Trying to make it 10-6. A kick on the way, and it's good. Hit it high and got it, barely. Ty Willingham says, we'll take it. So the block punt becomes a 40-yard field goal. Add on three for Notre Dame. It's 10-6.
Being an architect of the street is understanding the neighborhood, looking at people, understanding what they do, and decide where the best place they could find an ATM would be. You have to immerse yourself into the street, who's going to use the machine and how and when and where. Why are they going? Where are they going? Going to get a haircut, going to soccer practice. We understand the impact of a left turn, of a right turn, traffic signals, of sun glare. I look at the fancy cars and the not so fancy cars, the types of suits and shoes that people are wearing. And how does the Bank of America fit the needs of that neighborhood? My name is Jose Delgado. I'm a banker, and I'm proud to be part of Bank of America. We have around 14,000 ATMs across the country. If we don't place ATMs in the right positions, we'll have done a disservice to the customer, and the customer appreciates that. At the end of the day, we've done our job providing them that world-class service. Money at their fingertips. That's a beautiful thing.
Bank of America. Higher standards.
Get everybody in the country to drive the all-new Chevy Malibu. We think you'd agree. It's just about perfect.
The new Chevy Malibu. Available with OnStar. Visit ChevyMalibu.com for details.
Check that blitz. Check that safe.
It's on two.
Red 80, yo, watch the
new one-hour Charlie Brown Christmas special.
I'm the Santa Claus.
Soon to be a holiday classic. I want a dog for Christmas, Charlie Brown. ABC Tuesday.
So Notre Dame comes up with a block punt. They turn it into a field goal. They cut the lead to 10-6, Syracuse. And now Fitzpatrick will kick it away to Gregory and Morant. Back deep for Syracuse. It's a line drive. One of the up men touched it first, and now it's scooped up by Gregory. And Gregory busts out of there, out across the 40.
Gregory is the starting corner, defensive back for Syracuse, but he can run.
Ryan Lacasse is the guy that touched it, number 94, and that kind of set it up.
Yeah, well, everything's messed up right now, the blocking scheme and everything, but also the coverage team kind of relaxes when the ball goes down there squirrely.
So good field position for the Orangemen now. Their own 41-yard line. Fontenette trots way out. Wide to the left side. Both receivers that way, and now Fontenette comes back toward Anderson. Anderson's play action. He better get rid of it. Finally did to Reyes on a screen in the middle. And Waller got out near the 49-yard line. Tell you what, you play action against this defensive front of Notre Dame, you better turn around and get rid of it.
Well, Notre Dame plays an aggressive style of defense. They're man-to-man everywhere on the outside, so they have everybody up there to stop the run. And if you're going to throw it to Reyes, there's a linebacker looking right at him, especially if you just faked it to him. If you throw it to him, there's a linebacker right in his hip.
So second down and a long two coming up. There's the next two games we've got in our triple header. And both have a major impact on how it's all going to look when we roll January around. Anderson now an option. Looking for somebody to pitch to. Whoa, that's dangerous. I'm not sure that wasn't a forward lateral, too, but
it was at least a parallel.
Yeah.
Quarterbacks, I've said it all along, the main thing they have to do is make good decisions. mostly that I'm talking about throwing the football. But sometimes it's running the football, calling a check off at the line of scrimmage, or in this instance, that was forward.
Yeah, it sure was.
In this instance, whether or not to pitch it on the option, you have to make good decisions. Quarterbacks in the option or quarterbacks in the pocket throwing.
They're going to officially call that a completed one-yard forward pass. At midfield, third down, a big yard. Notre Dame all stacked up. Reyes busts out of it. Almost broke it. That had that look of that John Riggins run. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
And nobody home in the back.
How quickly your mind just snaps right to that one play. But you know why? On third, or especially on fourth and short, the defense is so committed to stopping and not allowing you to make the first down. And if you break by the first line of defense, there's only one guy left to go. And if you break that tackle, you're gone.
And that was Burrell, and he held on for dear life. First down, though, for Reyes and the Orangemen at the 44 of Notre Dame. Walter will take it again into the middle of the pile. Got about two. And then got buried. Watson led the charge as a middle linebacker. Reyes, the sixth back in Syracuse history to rush for over 2,000 yards in 3 years. The hometown is Struthers, Ohio. And he was not as highly touted as his cousin was. Going on to Ohio State, his cousin is Maurice Claret.
Uh-huh.
And Walter's having a lot better year than Maurice is. Second down and eight. Play action. Anderson steps up in the pocket, now throws short, comes back, got his tight end again, Cusumano. I tell you what, it's a Lenny Cusumano day. Yes, Bob said he hadn't caught many,
yeah,
but he's got two big ones today.
He's got a couple, and this, you know, this is his last game for Syracuse in this building, and he's going out with a bang. Two catches, that's 40% of what he had coming in.
He comes from a big Italian family, and he's scooping up the rewards today.
Notre Dame did a nice job defensively, covered downfield, come up and make the hit on the short throw.
Washington in at the tailback spot now, Tim Washington. And he'll get the pitch. Trying to cut it back inside. Broke one tackle. Got inside the 30 down near the 28. We'll give him a couple. And Anderson now slow to get up. Derek Curry is the guy that put the hit on RJ as he was tossing that pitch out there. And he took a pretty good lick. Right there.
Yeah, now that he fell on him, yeah.
It was the landing.
That's what those guys do, those defensive guys. Once they got you,
yeah,
then they fall on you.
The takeoff was great. The landing was a little rocky.
Yeah.
Yeah. Second down and seven.
I think the NFL does a better job, I've said it before, protecting their quarterbacks than college does.
Up the middle as they fake the end around, and they go off right tackle inside the 25. About four more, and it'll bring up third down and short.
I think that's one of the things in the offseason that the college football coaches, their rules committee, has to take a look at is protecting their quarterbacks. Because just like that hit there, you know, the hit was fine, but then falling to the ground with him, trying to grind him into the ground. And then when the quarterback is throwing, you know, hitting head-to-head and receivers downfield, helmet-to-helmet. You see a lot of that in college that is not called, but it is in the NFL.
Reyes back in at the tailback on third down and two. They fake it to him. Anderson waits, sends a crossing pattern to Morant. Morant inside the 10. First and goal, Syracuse. Oswani said it in the first half. That crossing pattern, when he gets those long legs going, is the perfect pass for this guy, and he just got another one.
Well, it's because he gets going. You don't jam him. You let him run in space. Now he finds his, weaves his way through all those white shirts. Now he's got the ball and he can get going.
And drop back in that zone coverage. And all you have to do is figure what the depth of the linebackers is going to be. If your assignment is to go underneath them, quarterback just picks you up. Then you look for a little crack upfield.
So it's first and goal now. Two tight ends, the option, the pitch to Walter Reyes. Reyes, touchdown, Syracuse. Walter Reyes, second of the day. On the ground, is 17th of the season. Three-yard touchdown has made it 16-6. Extra point coming.
As Bologna says, it's all right, offense, it's about time. The last three possessions, we had had two interceptions and a blocked punt. That time they took it the length of the field and got the touchdown.
So Colin Barber in for the point after. Up and good with 8:09 remaining in the half. Syracuse stretches its lead back out to 17-6, courtesy of the All-Big East performer, Walter Reyes. Second touchdown of the day.
Get everybody in the country to drive the all-new Chevy Malibu. We think they'd agree. It's just about perfect.
It's not your job.
It's not your accent.
It's not your clothes.
It's not your car.
It's not your lipstick.
It's not your friends. It's not your shoes.
It's not your laugh. It's not your hair.
Your watch.
You can tell more about a person by the watch they wear than anything else. Seiko Kinetic, powered by the movement of your body.
Hey, I thought you guys were off to Circuit City for that PlayStation 2.
We're going. Just want to make sure.
Yep, it's in stock.
Let's go.
Hey, you want to go?
No, I think you guys should probably just...
You're good to go. For product availability at a store near you, check CircuitCity.com. Circuit City, we're with you.
Want me to hold the bag?
No.
Please.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Circuit City. We're with you. The new Chevy Malibu and your local Chevy dealers. ADT, America's leader in business and home security. ADT, always there. And Miller Lite, there's good enough, and there's better than it has to be. Miller, good call. Pretty good call by Syracuse on that last play before the timeout. A touchdown of 3 yards. They lead 17-6. Carney's kick will go to the two to Dwight Alec. Alec got a nice block trying to cut it outside and almost lost the ball, but he held on and he got a nice return out of it out to the 30-yard line.
Alec's from a couple blocks from here, isn't he?
He sure is.
Pasqualoni was telling us about Ellick.
That's Justin Tuck, who went down to injury in the first quarter, leading sack producer for Notre Dame.
They not only had injuries on defense, but also on offense.
Yeah, we just saw Jamie Ryan come out.
Jamie Ryan is also on
crutches.
Dan Stevenson, who started at right guard, has been out.
Now Notre Dame in an 11-point hole with 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. Julius Jones trying to get going today, and he just can't. That Syracuse defense won't let him. Gashlin out there again, got help from Diamond Ferry from the secondary. Walter Reyes, 35 career touchdowns to tie Floyd Little, and most rushing touchdowns ever. When you get mentioned with Floyd or Ernie or Jim Brown or Larry Zonka or somebody like that around here.
Had a good bunch of good running backs around here.
Oh, I guess. No doubt about it.
And then there's Jim Ringo and John Mackey, who are also in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
John Mackey is here.
John's at the game. Here's Quinn, play action, floats it out. This is the one play for Notre Dame that keeps getting yardage.
Yeah, that usually whenever you got a fullback that can catch the football, and this kid right here, Schmidt, he was playing what amounted to being intramural football for Notre Dame. He's a walk-on, and he was tearing up this intramural league at Notre Dame, and they said, hey, you guys, you need to go over there and play for the big boys.
Yeah, we need a helmet on you, son.
Well, they had helmets.
Out of Germantown, Tennessee.
Yeah. That's his, he came in with 10 catches on the year. I think it's his third catch of the day.
Yep. Two out in the left flat, that one in the right flat. Third down and two, it still is, though, for the Irish. Humboldt. Ball still loose. Syracuse has got it.
And that comes from the defensive line causing havoc amongst that offensive line. Whenever you're a center or quarterback and that defensive line is on fire, this type of thing happens.
Gashlin's the guy that'll end up with it. Watch how long this ball stays on the deck.
The center had to snap the ball and then move to his left to try to cut off Ferrara, who's been a monster in there today.
And his teammate, defensive tackle Gashlin, with a fumble recovery.
Yeah, but it's been Ferrara that's been the man in there.
Oh, yeah. So Syracuse with an opportunity. With the turnover, trying to take advantage at the Notre Dame 35. They pump fake it and come back to Reyes. He's got a block early with him inside the 30. Reyes down the sideline, cuts back to the 15. Nice looking play. Adam Terry got a monster block for him out there on the corner, and he picked up 20.
When he pumps, the linebackers go. Watch him pump to the right. That takes the linebackers. Then he's got a blocker out there.
How about that hit by Terry, huh?
Got Curry down. Watson finally makes the play.
So now Syracuse down in the red zone again. They've got things rolling here in the third quarter. First down at the Notre Dame 15.
Reyes straight up the middle. Touchdown.
Remember when we told you about the explosive burst he has? We just saw it. 15 yards, touchdown. Bob, he came through that hole like a rocket.
Yeah, but it was the blocking up front that really set it up.
So Gashlin knows that his fumble recovery has just become 6 or 7. The extra point is upcoming. Barber's extra point up and good. And Notre Dame's in some trouble right now. 6:34 remaining in the third quarter. Reyes, as Bob said, had a hole to work through, and he shot through it. Touchdown, Orangemen.
We got a problem up here.
Tower 12, weather's moving it.
Heading up.
Do you have the right truck? Does your truck have a Duramax diesel? Does it have an Allison transmission? Silverado. It's the right truck. From Chevy. Silverado is the only full-size pickup available with OnStar.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
I will know my children are safe.
I will finally be able to relax!
At ADT, we help more people feel safe in more ways than any other security company. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide for zero down. Plus, save up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance. Call 1-800-ADT-ASAP.
To quit smoking, you need the right help. Introducing the Commit Lozenge. Clinically proven to help smokers quit, even those who tried before. And its medicine keeps working after the lozenge is gone. New Commit. Real help. Real hope.
Ho, ho, ho! God bless you, sir! Thank you!
It's an all-new holiday episode of According to Jim. Tuesday, 9, 8 Central on ABC.
Ho, ho! Hey, come on, come on!
Go back to the touchdown. Watch the blocking of the offensive line on the right side of the offensive line. The guard, Sampson and Green. Look at the work those two guys did in sealing off those two guys on the left side, on our left. Just enough to let Reyes squirt through the hole.
So Walter caps off the Chevy scoring drive. 35 yards in just two plays following the fumble recovery. His third touchdown on the ground today, and now he is alone on top. The most rushing touchdowns in a career, just having passed the aforementioned Floyd Little. Here's the kick.
And he comes back and plays another year.
Yes, he does. Big hit on the special teams now. Shelton took a shot.
And Notre Dame came out the beginning of the third quarter and blocked the first possession and took it in for a field goal, and they had all the momentum. But that has now changed over to Syracuse.
Darrell Kennedy made the hit on the kick return, and it was a dandy.
This whole thing started on that fumble, Notre Dame's fumble, and part of the breakdown is in the offensive line and the injuries to that offensive line. The one position, Stevenson at right guard, and his backup, Ryan, is hurt, and the fill-in, Mitchell, is also limping.
And with all of that, Syracuse has 14 points in 95 seconds. Quinn to throw, lofts it. Clark, the intended receiver, is incomplete. His tight end. Kelvin Smith, the linebacker, was out there covering. Second down and 10. We've seen some good defensive plays today by both teams. We're going to take a look at our defensive player of the year.
We've seen some good ones this year, haven't we?
Yeah, we sure have. Defensive play. Remember this game with Sean Taylor? There's like five Sean Taylors out there, it seemed like, on that day. Nine interceptions on the season. He was part of that big Miami victory over Florida State. And on the ground, much gained out here in the 18-yard line. Sean's the guy we showed. And
Teddy Lehman, the linebacker at Oklahoma, the number one defense in the country, was a great player this year. Sean Taylor from Miami, outstanding free safety. Could pick off the ball, could come up and force the run. Just some outstanding defensive play, but those are two of the best that we've seen this year.
Third down and 7. Getting loud in the dome again. Ryan Grant in it, tailback for Notre Dame. Standing on his defense, ready to pounce on Quinn, but they'll have to wait. Penalty markers down. Here's the call.
Prior to the snap, ball start. Okay. 5 yard penalty for the previous spot. Go third down.
That won't make it any easier on them. They walk off 5 yards. Third down at 12 coming up.
Part of the problem with the injuries in the offensive line for Notre Dame is the right guard, two of the right guards are out, and the right tackle, number 68, Harris, is a true freshman. So the guy he's been playing next to, Stevenson, all year long and telling him, helping him what to do, is no longer there.
Third down at 12. Quinn knows he's going to have some pressure. Here they come, and down he goes. Diamond Ferry from the secondary. This is a gem of a play by the Diamond. Boy, that wasn't much of a block.
That wasn't much of a block by Grant. He says, come on. You're supposed to block the guy. I knew you had supposed to block it. You know, just because there's an X in front of that O doesn't mean the X is going to handle the O.
Another tough spot now for the punter. Fitzpatrick gets it away. Williams waits on this one at the 49. Williams, nice move inside. He's shifty. He's got most of the quickness. That wide receiver core, one of the quickest guys out there, and he got a 13-yard return. Let's keep going with our players of the year. What do you think about comeback player of the year?
Yeah, I tell you, there's categories for a lot of different guys, but how about Lee Evans at Wisconsin? He was out a couple of years with a leg injury and came back.
I kind of like Julius Jones coming back from being an academic casualty here at Notre Dame.
How about Jeff Smoker?
Yeah, not bad.
At Michigan State, coming back after the problems that he had.
And, of course, Jason White will play tonight.
Yep.
40 touchdown passes already coming off that knee surgery. Here's the fullback, Greg Hanowin. We got a couple on the inside. Time permitting, remind you to stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. John, Terry, and Craig will have all the scores and highlights. Look ahead to the next two games we've got going on, the other games that are going on across the country today. And a lot of them have a bearing on who you'll see at the beginning of the year in the big BCS games.
Sound like a broken record again. Syracuse with great field position against that Notre Dame defense.
Second and 8, Anderson, heavy pressure, got it across the middle. Montnett made a nice catch in traffic and then dives back to the 30-yard line. Fontenette seeing more and more action today because of Jared Jones' ankle injury. And Fontenette, another good-sized target, just under 6'3", 230-pounder. Here's the games you'll see coming up next. Oregon State, number 2 USC, and then Big 12 championship.
Talking about coaches, two of the best coaches in the country, USC with Pete Carroll. What a great job he's done since he's gotten here. And Bob Stoops at Oklahoma, losing one of his assistants, though.
Yep. You never really lose a brother, though.
Oh, there's an interception thrown right to Courtney Watson. The middle linebacker down the sideline. Cuts back in. Morant will track him down, but he's all the way to the 24-yard line.
We've seen some poor throws by Anderson today. I don't know if that was his problem or the guy he was trying to get it to.
Yeah, that, I don't think that was as much his fault as the other ones might have been. From behind the defense, number 33 to the left of your screen, Belton wasn't even looking.
Nope, never even turned around.
But he shouldn't have thrown the ball because it was covered. Take a look from behind the offense. He threw it because he saw the linebacker coming. Now, you know, in practice, they probably throw that ball, one, two, three, and throw it.
Right.
But that doesn't mean in the games it's going to be that way. You have to wait and see what develops in the game.
47-yard return now. Can Notre Dame capitalize on this turnover? At the 24, Quinn, quick throw out, complete to Holiday, and he doesn't get much. Got it out there with a blocker in front of him, but only got about 4 yards out of it.
You got to pull for Carlisle Holiday, the guy that has started 25 games for the Irish earlier in the season, was the starting quarterback, and then was replaced by Brady Quinn, asked to go to wide receiver, still the backup quarterback, but he's got an opportunity to come back next year. He's got an opportunity to go play baseball, yep, professional baseball, so he's got some decisions to make.
He's thinking about coming back and making wide receiver the profession of choice. Here's Jones on the counter. Julius Jones breaks down into the 10-yard line and inside. In fact, Weish made the tackle. Pick up a 13 for Julius.
Like Bob and Brad, you started talking about coming back for a fifth year, Carlisle Holiday. Notre Dame has no less than 12 players who could possibly come back for a fifth year. And for many years, they had a policy with regards to a fifth year, and that was you had to have completed your degree and were working in graduate school. They have since changed that. But 12 players could come back on this team.
Well, that'd help them. That experience never hurts. From the 9 now, Jones. It looked like a face mask, but no flag. Just tackled high and dropped for a loss of a yard or two.
The two safeties for Syracuse have had big days. 22 Ferry right there. And number 20, Anthony Smith. Smith with an interception and a couple of big tackles. Ferry making the sack a little bit earlier in the ballgame.
There's where I thought I saw a face mask. And,
yeah.
Well, it was in the ballpark, huh? Got it off just in time, at least not to be detected. Not a face mask if you don't get caught, I guess. Grant back in the tailback. Second and goal now at the 11. Quinn throws, completes. Down to about the 5 to the night. And Scanlon stays right there with him. So it's going to be third down and goal. Julius Jones, by the way, moved one spot up farther on single season rushing list with his last carry.
I don't think he's going to move any further up the list.
Yeah. And one of those guys, Alan Pinkett, is here. One of the analysts of the Notre Dame Network. Saw him before the game.
I thought that was Paul Harning's job. Watch how low my man Quinn gets.
Yeah.
You can't even see him.
And he's 6'4". Nice play fake. He throws. Got a man. It's a touchdown. Good play. Anthony Fasano. All the Italian tight ends are getting in the act today.
Cusimano, Fasano.
We got it.
I went to a nice Italian restaurant the other night. Antonio's with Sister Virginia.
There you go.
Yes.
28 seconds left, and Quinn's going to stay out there to go for two.
Now they're going to go for two to try and make it a 10-point game.
That touchdown pass for Brady, his ninth of the year.
They work on these plays now. They have a bunch of two-point conversion plays that they'll work on throughout the week in a certain time of the practices.
Timeout taken by Syracuse with 28 seconds left in the quarter. Take another look at the touchdown.
Go to fake this way. Oh, that's the old sneak. That's the tight end behind. Yeah. I like that play. You see that play running the NFL a lot. The Broncos are running. Watch. Here's a tight end over here. He's going to run behind the line of scrimmage. Wow, he's coming behind. Everything's faking to the left, and Fasano's coming behind the line of scrimmage. We ran that play 25 years ago.
Who'd you throw it to, Mandich or
look,
somebody?
Look
or?
How low he gets.
And he reminds me of the backup quarterback for Ohio State who got down that low.
Yeah.
What a great play this is. When the tight end gets out, look at the pressure they put on Scanlon. If he doesn't stay back with the other tight end, one guy comes open. If he moves forward, he lobs it over his head. That's why they still run those plays, Bob. They haven't figured out how to stop them yet.
I tell you what, Swan, and you know it as well as I. Imitation is the highest form of flattery. If a defense or a team gets beat by a play and they can't stop it, they're going to put it in and run it themselves.
Exactly. And you know what the greatest play is in that category, Bob? I think I watched them do a special on the play on ESPN, the old sprint right pick. Remember that one?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Two-point conversion. Quinn has time over the middle. Broke up, though. Incomplete. Dalvin Smith, the guy that broke it up, was intended for Jared Clark, the tight end. So 24-12 is where we're at after the failed conversion. How about the ill-advised move of the year? We were all in agreement on this one.
Well, this was Michigan punting against Iowa. Now watch, they split out all the wide splits they took, and then once they get to snap the ball, all the guys that are blocking take off to the left. They don't block anybody. And the punter goes to the right. Well, what happens? Well, of course.
The old double punt.
The ball gets blocked. We thought we were missing something, but
they did that a couple times in that game, and that's the last we saw of it.
Yeah, they got rid of that.
But we were all in agreement.
But they lost that game.
Yes, they do, and they did, and that's part of the reason
Michigan
they
lost that game. And had they not lost that game, there are two one-loss teams that are second and third in the nation, USC and LSU. They're fourth.
Yep.
Michigan's fourth. They may be up in front of those two had Michigan not lost that Iowa game.
There's what we're talking about. Oklahoma, number one, the BCS standings, USC and LSU. Everybody wondering, after today's games, where that'll all fall into place.
No, I think...
Right now, Notre Dame's not doing USC any favors. Gregory comes through off to the 28-yard line. Again, I think everybody that's a football fan realizes this, but this game today, if Notre Dame loses, it would hurt USC's strength of schedule because Notre Dame would fall to 5-7, and that hurts them, and they're only 1.53 ahead.
Yeah, but I don't think it would hurt 1.53 that much. You know, and you ought to get used to seeing Oklahoma and USC at the top of any standings because I was looking at their rosters the other day.
They're young.
They have a lot of guys coming back on both sides of the ball, a lot of guys.
At the 29-yard line. First down, Syracuse. Here's a counter to Reyes, who has three touchdowns today. And he breaks free down the sideline. Reyes, one man to beat. He might be gone. He is. Touchdown, Syracuse. 71 yards. If you're going to get a fourth touchdown, you might as well do it with a little style. We just heard some cheers from LSU fans. Season-long run for Walter.
He's breaking out of it today.
Yes, he is. He now has 155 yards on the ground and four touchdowns. Extra point is good. 31-12. Ties his career high. He's done this before, but never with this much panache, I don't think. Watch this last one.
Gets a little help from Cerullo, the left guard. He's going to come around. Right there, he gets a little help. Now he's just going to outrun him.
We told you he was fast. Notre Dame thought they had an angle, and that angle disappeared in a hurry.
I tell you, he wears 39, not 44, of the Ernie Davis and Jim Brown era. So I'm telling you, they would be awfully proud of the power that he's shown in this ballgame today. And then that kind of speed, that is reminiscent of the kind of power and speed that the Jim Browns and Ernie Davises had when they played for Syracuse.
All right, here's a trivia question for you guys. He's got 39. Who wore 39 here?
Well, the greatest 39 I know was Sam Cunningham at USC, but Larry Johnson would be good.
There you go. You guys, I tell you what, one guy who jumps on whatever.
Yeah, thing, I know that.
You know, that Affleck trivia, he's ahead, you know, but we come up here early, and he hangs around down there,
yeah,
snooping in the windows and all that stuff.
The way it is.
We got a shot of him doing that.
Bob, I played with Gary Anderson. How could I not know Gary Anderson?
There's Walter's numbers in the first half and the second half. And speaking of Larry Zonka, only Larry Zonka and Joe Morris ever before Walter Reyes were guys to have back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons in Syracuse history. So he's in great company, and that company's only going to get better. I don't know if you ever get down up to Joe's all-time rushing mark, Joe Morris. But he's adding to it nicely here today. Let's check in at Times Square Stadium with John in New York.
Brad, time for the Killians update. This is the 1AA quarterfinals. Colgate's Jamal Branch goes in from a yard out. You can believe it, through all of the snow. That's his second touchdown of the game. They're tearing down the post as Colgate moves on now. 14-0 on the season for all our Colgate alum.
See, that game's fun to play in.
That's not far from here.
No.
They're just right outside the door here. That's it. We could have had that type of game. Or we could have had this.
I said they're fun to play, and I didn't say they're fun to broadcast in. As a throw complete at the Jenkins.
No, wait a minute. Go back. They're not fun to play in either.
It just looks like
if you're trying, if you're an offensive player trying to create in something like that, there ain't much. I mean, you're slipping and sliding, and the ball is wet, and you're cold, and
Bob, Brad, and I was trying to give my weather report out there. I was just standing there during rehearsal, and I fell down. What I didn't know was that we were, like, shooting that, and it was on the stadium scoreboard. When I came in, people kept asking, are you all right? I said, I'm glad I'm not playing.
Well, he wiped out a couple times out there doing a stand-up weather report. Grant going nowhere. Loss of two. Who else? Ferrara. And Scanlon's there with him. End of three. Right now, the Orangemen have this one in control, but we still got our fourth quarter to play. 31-12. Our presentation of college football will continue after this message and a word from our ABC station. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
Can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer!
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer. I can't taste my beer.
Next time, try the light beer that actually tastes like beer. Great tasting, less filling, Miller Lite. Good call.
Get everybody in the country to drive the all-new Chevy Malibu. We think you'd agree. It's just about perfect.
The new Chevy Malibu. Available with OnStar. Visit ChevyMalibu.com for details.
Sunday, with his client on trial for murder.
One low life down, one to go.
A lawyer will do anything to win.
Can't we all just get along?
But his tactics could go too far.
Do you think you're capable of behaving like a professional?
You trying to get me convicted?
An all-new practice after Alias, ABC Sunday, starting at 9, 8 Central.
You make it clear I own this town.
Tuesday night, ABC shattered the boundaries of network television.
Why is Malloy always one step ahead of us?
This Tuesday, prepare to cross the line again.
What do you want me to do? Steal the money back?
Yeah.
Go, go, go!
FBI!
A new line of fire, Tuesday at 10, 9 Central on ABC.
you needed your insurance, who would you call? Not the name of the company, but the name of the person. You've got 2 seconds. Coming up blank, you may want to consider Allstate. You'd have a local agent you can count on, a licensed professional whose name you know, not just a number. You deserve a relationship with a real person. That's Allstate Stand. Are you in good hands?
To get your kids ready for the bus stop, turn to 13, the Weather Authority.
Set to start the fourth quarter. Syracuse leading Notre Dame 31-12. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew in snowy Syracuse, but in the dome, things are warming up for the Orangemen. Quinn, slip screen throw, complete to McKnight. Nice spin move, stays on his feet, and he's all the way out near the 45-yard line. Scanlon, middle linebacker, finally tracked him down. Pickup of 16.
McKnight is only a sophomore. His quarterback is a true freshman. Stovall is a sophomore. They got a couple of freshman wide receivers that have played some this year. So Ty's got this Notre Dame squad moving in the right direction. Last year when he came in and won his first 8 games, he was left with a veteran squad, especially offensive and defensive linemen that were leaders and dominators at their positions.
Quinn, the throw, intended for Holiday, incomplete.
So Ty won early last year, and then he finished, he kind of cooled off. He lost all those players. Now it's kind of been a rebuilding thing for him.
Well, since the 10-1 start of the Irish last year, they have gone 5-8 since.
But he's got this program headed in the right direction. You know, the recruiting, several of their assistant coaches didn't fly out here with the team. They were recruiting in Chicago and other places. In fact, one of them had to drive up today from Newark.
I wouldn't want to do that right
now. Because of the snow in the area.
Second and 10 at the 44. Here's Jones. And maybe a yard.
You know, and we talked, Brad, about neither one of these teams qualifying for a bowl. You know what? Even if you go to there are 28 bowl games. So 56 teams out of 117 Division 1A.
Almost half of them.
Almost half go to bowls. Now, what's the advantage? Would you rather just barely get in and go to any bowl? Well, yes, because
15 more practice.
You get 15 more practice days to practice for that. And all the coaches will tell you that that's like having another spring practice.
Quinn will work from the gun on third and long. Fires down the left sideline. Stovall, it's intercepted. Anthony Smith got his second. Had one in the first quarter. He's got one in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and the freshman wide receiver that he was throwing to in Duque, who played in high school with Quinn, should have gone up and knocked the ball down, but he just ignored it. Said to us, didn't throw it to me, so I'm not going to try for it. You got to go down and battle. Number 81. If you can't get it, don't let the defensive guy get it.
So Smith's got his second pick.
See, I'm always looking out after my quarterbacks.
I notice you are.
Yeah.
I thought Swanee was going to chime right in there.
He knew I was right.
I'm just giving you a moment.
he's trying to think of something else.
Reyes breaks free again. Reyes with a blocker in front, down the sideline, all the way out to the 44-yard line. Reyes putting up a 200-yard game before this one's over. Let's check in with John in New York.
And the Taco Bell update, more Division 1 AA quarterfinal action. Delaware against Northern Iowa. Antoine Jenkins 7 yards in for a touchdown and a 37-7 win. Delaware going on to the semifinals for the fifth time as they win easily.
You know, they get the playoffs in all these other divisions.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you a story.
Anderson off play action. Wants to go deep for Morant, and the pass went one way. Morant ran to the post.
And see, that's a great example of, in practice, that's where we threw it. Down the field, so that's where Anderson threw it. Now, they got to get together. I mean, Morant read something in the secondary that he broke the route off. Well, the quarterback's got to find out. Just because we run in practice, that's not the way we're going to run. But anyway, getting back to these playoffs.
Yes.
Florida Atlantic is in the playoffs against Northern Arizona. Who do you think is the coach of Florida Atlantic?
Howard Schnellenberg.
There you go.
They're going Division 1A next year.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't make these too hard for these guys. I mean, I know
you try to stay within my realm of brain power.
Yeah, there you go.
Second and 10. Late pitch to Washington, who's in there. You saw Walter Reyes kind of working his shoulder a little bit. He got driven out of bounds pretty good on that last long run. Swanee?
Well, guys, you were talking about national champions. There's a national champion in the house, and that is Carrie-Anne Lynch. She is a national baton twirling champion, and she won the national collegiate championship at Disney World this year, plus several other collegiate championships at Notre Dame, and she's going to be performing on the sideline at the Sugar Bowl, so Syracuse will be represented.
In the big game. Good for her.
Oh, Scott. Oh, Swanee. He gets around, doesn't he?
He does. He does really get around.
He gets around.
Third down and flags down.
But Howard Schnellenberger at Florida Atlantic, they were only in their third year of football.
Offense.
False start.
Let's go third down.
Third down at 13 now. Paul Pasqualoni, his team looking like it's going to be 6-6. And there's been so much speculation about Coach P and whether or not this would be his last game at the Carrier Dome after 13 seasons. And I mentioned earlier, Ben Schwartzwalder, of course, is the all-time record holder for wins. But here's a guy in 13 years, won 100, and it looks like it's going to be 101 games.
Yep.
It's always, what have you done for me lately in this business?
He's loved in the community.
Down the middle. Anderson got Moran on the run, and here he goes. Got a block. Inside the 30. Finally run out of bounds. Not before he got down inside the 15. What Swanee say about those crossing patterns that work for this kid? I think he's got something there. 44 yards.
Notre Dame is not getting up in their face and jamming them. There he is at the top of your screen. Now watch. Nobody's going to run with him. That means it's a zone coverage. Notre Dame coming into the game had done nothing but play a lot of zone, I mean, man coverage, where Duff, who is injured, is not in there, gets up in his face and just jams him.
Toss now to Washington.
Whoa.
And he's run out of bounds. At about the 13.
Belton, the fullback, gets a block. Not only one block, but two and three blocks. 43.
That's why you call him Thump.
He shoves him down, knocks him down.
Old Thumper. Just inside the 14-yard line. Second down, a long eight. Washington up the middle. Inside the 10. Adir Miri, the guy in on the stop. Syracuse with a third down. They can get a first down at about the 4-yard line. The trips to the red zone have been pretty fruitful. The only one that went haywire was the bad pass by Anderson, was intercepted by Notre Dame. Both tight ends in there, and a four receiver look. Might be a quarterback draw. It's going to be an option. And Washington cuts back inside. Boy, he's close. He might have it. I didn't think he had a prayer. He's very close. That last effort got him pretty close to the first down. They are not going to measure, I guess. About a half yard to go. Well, maybe they are going to measure. They'll bring the sticks out, make sure the Carrier Dome is flat. Looks like it's just inches short, but we'll wait and see. And that's inches. Fourth down and about five links plus a piece of tape. They leave the offense in. And Walter Reyes in there.
And guys, the trainer just told me that Walter's going to go back in the ballgame, as you see, but he does have a bit of a bruised right shoulder.
Yeah, that's what he was working after that last long run down the left sideline when he was tackled right in front of the Syracuse bench. He was kind of rotating that right shoulder, trying to get it warmed up. If he gets the call here and goes in for the touchdown, it would be five on the day. Just outside the 4-yard line. They go to that full house backfield again. And it's going to be the quarterback. And R.J. Anderson does it himself. So first and goal for Syracuse. Talking with Coach Pasqualoni, talked the one game I think that's really stuck in their craws. They're about two plays away from having Miami right where they wanted them, and they let them off the hook.
Yeah, they lost to Miami down in Miami, 17-10. And he was talking about that one the other day. But what a good job he's done getting these guys ready to play against Notre Dame.
First and goal. Reyes, the tailback, gets the call right side. There's number five. Touchdown, Syracuse. Boy, I guess so. Those big fellas, those big eaters, they should be showing off a little bit. He's just tied Floyd Little for the second most touchdowns ever in a game. Floyd did it against Kansas in 64. Now Walter Reyes has his fifth touchdown of the day. Extra point by Barber coming up. Barber's extra point is good. And all Syracuse right now with 10.5 to play. Here comes touchdown number five for Walter Reyes. It's 38-12, Orangemen.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
Rate on a great car, go thrifty.com.
We have so many stories in the archives.
If you know what's worked in the past, there's no question about what you should be doing in the present and in the future.
Every time new technology has emerged, the result of it has been to make banking easier for you and me.
And we built the first computer used in banking. But before we could do that, we had to have a machine-readable numbering system. So we invented those little numbers. Because we had all of that in place, we could launch the first nationally accepted credit card, which changed the nature of money for people.
I'm Kathleen Collins, and I'm the corporate archivist for Bank of America. Our Texas banks were the very first to develop financial products that could enable oil exploration. We had a hand in building the first bridge across the Mississippi River.
Even in the building of the Golden Gate Bridge, other bankers said it was financial suicide.
We wouldn't have this bridge if it weren't for the bank.
It's a very noble history,
and I'm proud to be part of Bank of America.
Bank of America, higher standards.
For our lowest rate on a great car, go thrifty.com.
Monday, here's something you may not know. There are forces working against you, making it hard to stay healthy. Why? Peter Jennings reporting, How to Get Fat Without Really Trying, Monday.
Give that man some ice. He deserves it. So do his offensive linemen. That's Walter Reyes, who just scored his fifth touchdown of the day on the ground and has given Syracuse a 38-12 advantage. Dwight Alec on the kick return. Alec out to the 20. That's it. Let's take a look at that last touchdown.
Watch the guard right here. That's Tarullo. Watch, he's going to pull and get a block. Tarullo, 75. Watch him now. Takes a block. Now he kind of helps him down. Takes him down. Now the thing that Matt needs to know is, now watch him when he gets up. Watch him, what he's going to do here. The thing he needs to know is, not only is his offensive team going to look at these films, and Notre Dame is going to look at these films, but you know what? The officials look at these films. And they see that he's so excited about getting away with holding that the next time they do a game with Matt Tarullo, they're going to be looking for him.
I don't think he cares right now.
I don't think he cares either.
There he is.
He'll be back. Just a junior. Three members of that offensive line for Syracuse will be back. Terry, Terullo, and Franklin Green, the backup, will be back.
Nick Romeo won't be. He's the center who started for the 48th straight time today. And only one other guy in Syracuse history has put up those kind of numbers. Here's a pass. Shelton caught it twice. Hit him in the hands and the chest, and it bounced off, and he caught it again.
I like that kid.
I do, too.
He's got a lot of spunk.
The guy that started 49 games in his Syracuse career is a pretty good quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles right now. So when Nick Romeo goes out in his last game, which looks like it's going to be a win, he said, hey, you know what? If you can mention me right after Donovan, I'm in pretty good company.
That's for sure.
Incomplete, 9:26 remaining.
You know what's happened in this game? We were talking to Paul Pasqualoni yesterday. He says, he said the same thing on the field before the game. He said, our playmakers have to make plays. He says, the quarterback has to make plays, the running back has to make plays, and the receiver.
Well, Morant's made some big ones.
Morant's.
And Reyes has done the rest.
Morant has caught six for 103 yards. Reyes is
189 yards and five touchdowns.
There you go.
On 19 carries.
And R.J. Anderson has passed for over 209 yards. Even though he's thrown three interceptions, he has still made some plays in the positive side of it.
And with all that in mind, I'm still not sure I wouldn't give those two defensive tackles the player of the game. They've been something inside. Here's Quinn. They're still chasing him. They hit him again. And that's incomplete. And Knight pinned that against the carpet trying to catch it. And it was Gashlin who let Brady Quinn have it again. Now, we've seen great offensive performance by Reyes today, and we've seen some good ones this year, offensive performances. And we're going to take a look at our offensive performance of the year as we go along. Fourth down and two.
Oh.
High snap, handled, and he got the kick away. Taken by Williams. There was a block involved there, too. Not much of a return, but a big hit. Only a 3-yard return. Timeout with 9:08 remaining in the ballgame. 38-12 Syracuse.
In 1868, an American tradition was beginning, and Pacific Life was founded. Both built on principles of persistence, performance, and strength. 135 years later, those beliefs still guide Pacific Life. It's how we help so many businesses and individuals reach their financial goals. For insurance, annuities, and investments, rely on the strength of Pacific Life, proud sponsor of the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl.
Step up and taste. This calls for Killian's.
When love is all we need. Yeah, all we need. Oh, don't you find that ironic call? When love is all we need. Oh, yeah.
Oh, PT Cruiser. Total Quality Award winner 3 years running.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV. Old Navy. Old Navy will hook you up for the holidays. And Killian's Irish Red, Irish in spirit, a step up in taste. Well, it's great to be an Orangeman today.
Are those the same gals and guys that cheered for the basketball team? I mean, they were holding up number one.
Well, yeah, they did it last year. Coach Boeheim was here earlier in the press box. Talked to him briefly at halftime. And now on the ground, Washington's going to get his chance because Walter Reyes' day is done. We take a look at our Chrysler passing playbook, Bob.
All right, here we go. The quarterback is basically going to do one of three things. You're going to run a receiver deep down the middle. You're going to have a guy running a square end short, and then you're going to have a guy short. So you got three areas, deep, middle, and short. Let me show you how these guys are running. I'm going to show you right here. Here's the deep, here's the middle, and here's the short. Now, you read one, two, and three. That's the way the quarterback likes to do it. You read deep to short, and that time the middle area was wide open.
He got two, zone two there, two number two for a big gainer.
Yes, sir.
On the ground, first down run by Darrell Kennedy. Walter Reyes, by the way, with his day done at 189 yards, is going to end up just a shade shy of the single season rushing record for Syracuse that Joe Morris owns of 1,372 yards. And that great performance by Walter today.
We had defensive player of the year, you know. We had coach of the year.
Yep.
I'm going to show you who the defensive player is.
Offensive player.
Offensive player.
We'll do that after this snap if something big doesn't happen. Draw play. And Washington goes down. Loss of a yard. We take a look at our offensive player of the year in college football. Again, these are the ones that Bob and Lynn and I have chosen. This isn't any scientific poll. This is just who we think. And Bob's choice, Jason White. So was Swanee's. I picked Larry Fitzgerald of Pittsburgh, and that certainly wasn't to slight Jason White's 40 touchdowns.
There's no question Fitzgerald is outstanding here.
Second down and 11. Montanet, they fake it to him, and they pitch it to Washington going wide. Got the corner, got the sideline. Not stopped before he's hit out at the 27-yard line.
Abby Amiri, the big defensive end, I think he's finished for the day after chasing him around the end. Going to come here. I think that's Abby Amiri right there, the big freshman. Little pitch.
Yeah,
goes down the line. Long legs.
Victor's going. Somebody knocked this guy out.
Oh, boy. It's like running gassers after practice.
First down at the 27. Washington into the middle. Anderson tripped up a little bit, just giving him the handoff. Don't forget Oregon State, number two USC, follows us. And then the Big 12 championship, Kansas State against the top-ranked and undefeated Oklahoma Sooners. That's the next two in our triple header here on ABC.
Talk about players that came out of nowhere this year. How about Leinart?
Oh, boy,
Matt Leinart. Replacing Carson Palmer, the Heisman Trophy winner for USC, the quarterback. Who are they going to get? They got one of four guys. They fill somebody up. And here comes Matt Leinart.
And he's put up better numbers than Palmer did winning the Heisman Trophy.
Outstanding year. What a great year.
You'll see him next on ABC.
He was just outstanding. And then one of the, you know, this has really been the year of the receiver. There have been tremendous receivers. And I think at the very top is Larry Fitzgerald at Pittsburgh. Only a sophomore. But the Mike Williams, the
Mike
wide
Williams
receiver
at USC.
We saw him a couple weeks ago. He was outstanding.
Roy Williams at Texas. Reggie Williams at Washington. You go down, you just get the Williams guys and the Clayton boys, and you got a pretty good
Williams,
receiving group.
Clayton's and, and don't be surprised if you see Johnny Moore possibly in this drive, if they keep the drive alive. Which they are not. I'm not sure they made that first down.
That's pretty close.
Going to be close to probably measure. But Johnny Morant, number two. I would say don't be surprised if they threw him an attempt to get him into the end zone. It wouldn't be piling it on. It would be actually an early birthday present because, you see, tomorrow, on December 7th, Johnny Morant will be 22 years old.
Happy birthday tomorrow to Johnny. It's going to I tell you what, he can start a party tonight.
Yeah,
he can.
They're
going to win.
But we'll say happy birthday to him beforehand. Also, our respect and honors to go out to all those people in the military because, as you know, tomorrow is also Pearl Harbor Day. So we send out our respect and love to men and women in the military.
Absolutely. I know that some of you are watching on Armed Forces TV overseas. We wish you a happy holiday. And, of course, the Commander-in-Chief's trophy is still up for grabs this afternoon, too. And the Navy, with an opportunity to win that, they've had a great season.
Haven't they?
Navy lost in the last play of the ballgame to Notre Dame, but still 1-7.
There you go.
Who's hot? Who's not? Navy makes the list. Sylvester Croom. Yeah, we had him with us earlier.
on the hot list. I can't wait to
see Miami, Ohio. Great year they had.
They ran 12 in a row off after losing their opener. And they've still got a bowl game in front of them after winning the MAC championship. Who's not? I always can't wait to see this. You don't tell me any of this stuff. So who's on the Bob's who's not list?
You ought to come in the truck, boy. When we start doing this, everybody comes in.
Yeah.
Everybody's got an opinion.
Uh-oh, the Nebraska athletic director, Steve Peterson's on your who's not list.
Yeah, Frank Solich wins 9 games and doesn't have a job.
And here, Paul Pasqualoni's going to win his 6th. And there's speculation on whether that's good enough. But certainly today, boy, great job getting this team ready. And they have played as well as they played all year. And they're playing a quality opponent in Notre Dame and winning handily right now, 38-12.
Big win.
Here's Washington behind his blockers. Dropped at the 20.
You know, yesterday when we sat down and talked to Paul Pasqualoni, you know, I asked him a question about how things are going here at his school and about his contract and about Frank Solich. And his comment was that he felt that maybe somewhere along the way, somebody at Nebraska lost confidence.
Yep.
He believes that's why there are changes. And I asked him how he felt about his position here. He said he believes that everyone here still has confidence in him. And that was his position. That was his feeling on it.
The athletic director, Jake Krauthammel, has been here as AD for over 25 years. And so he and Paul obviously go back a long way. Anderson's in trouble, and down he goes. But every year, they get together, Paul Pasqualoni and his athletic director, usually the day after or 2 days after the final regular season game, and said, we talk about the future and what's going to happen, evaluated every year. He said, I figure when Jake walks in my office on Monday, it'll have a little different look to it maybe, but it's still an evaluation, so we'll see how it goes.
Yeah, and it'll probably be, it could possibly be tomorrow, Sunday.
Yes.
That's when those things normally get done.
Tell you what, if you're a Syracuse fan, you can't go home not being happy today.
That's for sure.
Good job by he and his entire staff getting this team a mile high, ready to play this one. And while there was a moment where the momentum looked like it was going Notre Dame's way, that turned quickly, and it's been all orange ever since. Screen pass again to McKnight. Same play they used the last time they were on offense for Notre Dame. So Notre Dame will fall to 5-7. With this loss, and their 3-game winning streak goes by the boards.
You know, we've had the best of the best coach, the best of this, the best of that. You know, let me ask you one. I don't know if we're going to get up or not, but MVP, the most valuable player. Most valuable player to his team. The guy without whom the team would not nearly have done as well.
I would say probably Eli Manning, maybe.
I like that pick.
You like that pick?
I like that pick.
That's one anyway. There's a bunch.
How long has it been? How long has it been since Mississippi won or tied for the division chance? And how long has it been since they've been to the Cotton Bowl?
Right. Yeah. And that's where they're going.
He was outstanding.
We'll be right back. 2:48 remaining in the ball game here with Syracuse in control.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
Taco Bell's Fajita Grilled Stuffed Burrito. Sizzling marinated carne asada steak and tasty fajita veggies. Wrapped and grilled to go.
I should have gotten fajitas.
Nothing beats the sizzle when you think outside the bun.
For our lowest rate on a great car, go thrifty.com.
Sprint's got wireless and wireline integrated, managed as one seamless network.
Yeah, but we're meeting with AT&T.
And AT&T Wireless.
Huh?
Hi.
Hello.
How you doing?
Hi. How are you?
AT&T.
AT&T Wireless.
So when do we meet with Sprint?
Two guys, one suit. You should have seen it.
Sometimes seeing is believing.
Get integrated wireline and wireless services from one company. Get the facts at Sprint.com. One Sprint, many solutions.
Riveting. Compelling. Suspenseful. Incredible. Line of Fire. ABC Tuesday, 10, 9 Central.
Back at Syracuse, our Pacific Life game summary with just a little less than 3 minutes remaining in the ballgame. Brady Quinn has had to keep throwing it today, but it was the rushing of Walter Reyes really that was the story for Syracuse in the ballgame. That and their stout defense. A couple interceptions by Anthony Smith. The two defensive tackles had brilliant games. And Syracuse leads 38-12.
Notre Dame didn't have field position all day long.
No. Quinn still throwing. This one is complete. Picked up of about five out to his tight end, Fasano, who caught a touchdown. The only touchdown for Notre Dame today was the tight end, Fasano.
Bottom line is, Brad, anytime you start a freshman quarterback, a true freshman in college, or a rookie quarterback in the pros, you're not going to do anything. You're not going to win anything. So this year for Notre Dame, even as much as they don't like to admit it, was a growing year. It was
right.
Time to get some experience for the young kid that's going to be our star for the next 3 years.
I want to thank all the folks that helped us all year long. This is part of our family, all the guys and gals that are with us every week. And we do hang around a lot together away from football, I might add, as well. And we want to thank everybody that helped us all year long and will be with us at the Orange Bowl as well coming up in January. Our technical managers, Joe Caracone, Kelly Nagy, our production manager, our technical directors, Randy Hargrove, our spotter, Clint Dean, statistician, Pat McGrath, our bug operator, Paul Barnes, Anthony Holman, our computer stats stage manager all year long, Asha Rubin, Corey Taylor and Tom Wirtz, our production assistants, our associate director, Dick Ellis, associate producer, Matt Marvin. Today's game directed by Steve Beim and produced by Bruce Clark. The director of production is Mark Loomis. Coordinating producer of ABC's College Football is Bob Goodrich. Our senior producer of ABC Sports is Bob Toms. Executive producer of ABC Sports, Mike Pearl. And the president of ABC Sports and ESPN is George Bodenheimer. Those are our people and our family, and we thank them for everything they do every week for us. To make Bob and Swanee and I look good.
Good job. Good job, everybody.
Pass incomplete intended for McKnight. So we will gather one more time all together. We'll take a little holiday break and then resume our partnership at the Orange Bowl. Don't forget two more games coming up today that will determine who's going bowling where. Oregon State will play USC. And then it's Kansas State and Oklahoma for the Big 12 championship. And we wish good luck to all those teams. And, of course, the LSU-Georgia game is going to have a bearing on what goes on as well.
So the bottom line, after this game is over with, this weakens Southern Cal's
yes.
schedule and helps in some way, shape, or form LSU if they win and SC wins.
So the LSU fans, the folks in Baton Rouge who have watched us today with that in mind, we know that you're happy. That Gatorade bucket is looming.
Standing right behind these guys, these big offensive linemen.
You just got that feeling that Paul's about to have an early shower.
Sampson and Romero, I think that is. And they're back there. the big offensive and defensive linemen, those are the guys.
Well, if they're going to throw it on them, please throw it on them before I get close. That's all I ask.
That's right. Swanee doesn't want to be in the line of fire. Fourth down, maybe the last play of the ballgame here for Notre Dame, and it is offensively. As it's incomplete. And we'll take a timeout with 1:12 remaining and come back and watch the Syracuse celebration in a moment.
All Navy Holiday Hotline, Eyes of Blue, I'll connect you. Hot pink, I should think. Quit monkeying around. How about a little logo? Go-go. Let it snow.
Let it snow. That look is off the hook.
Yeah, and my shizzle's gone for zizzle.
Half zips make great gifts for the whole family, just $10 to $15.
Thank you.
There are no gold medals for the 4x4 that masters Arctic snow. There are no championship games for fording muddy water. And there are no finish lines for the one that makes it over stacks of treacherous boulders. So why do we make sure every Jeep 4x4 is trail rated to such strict standards of capability? Perhaps the better question is, why doesn't everyone else? If it's not trail rated, it's not a Jeep 4x4.
When buying life insurance, the first rule is, make sure your life insurance company will outlive you. Life insurance, loans, retirement. AIG. We know money.
A cool zing after shaving feels good. Nivea gives you that refreshing feeling and improves your skin with moisturizers and vitamins. Nivea for Men Fresh Cooling Aftershave Balm. It cools and improves.
Final minute here as Syracuse will take over right at the midfield stripe. Harry Patterson in, the number two quarterback, is R.J. Anderson's day and career are done here at Syracuse, as our 15 other seniors are going to be a happy group of guys today and tonight, and they'll go into the offseason with a good taste in their mouth, and so will that guy who wins his 101st game as the head coach of the Orangemen. If I was him, I'd watch out because there's some shenanigans going on down behind him with his offensive lineman. Ty Willingham on the other side. Their season will finish. They've only had 11 losing seasons in Notre Dame's 116-year history, so another one's about to be added to it. And the fullback, Darryl Kennedy. Probably going to be the last snap that we'll see. There's where the shenanigans are about to happen, I think. Well, they backed away from that now. Yeah. They had that thing in their hands. Romeo and those other offensive linemen, they decided they're not going to do it, I guess. So the coach will have a regular shower when this one's all over. And final 17 seconds. Ball was actually fumbled at the very end of the play. And so Notre Dame does have another snap or two. 17 seconds still left. Well, if I was Notre Dame, I think I'd take a knee and not try to get anybody hurt in 17 seconds in a losing cause. And apparently that's what's going to happen. Quinn will take the last snap.
That's the funny way to end the season.
Yeah,
that's the last play for both teams.
Yeah, you'd like a kneel down in a different situation. In this case, win for Syracuse, a big one, a loss for Notre Dame, and a final score 38-12. As Walter Reyes had a monster day. He's got the pads off because of a sore shoulder, but the rest of him feels pretty good right now, I think. 5 touchdown rushing performance and 189 yards on the ground. So the final score is 38-12. Syracuse wins its 6th ball game of the season, so it's not a losing season for them. 6-6. Let's go down to Swanee.
Well, Coach, when we talked to you, you talked about this really being a game of pride, and your seniors and players gave you everything you asked for.
They really did. We're very proud of the way the kids came back. We had a very disappointing week. In a lot of ways, we've had a disappointing season. But these kids have fought through the adversity. They're really high-character guys, and we're really proud of the kids, the program, and what it stands for.
It seemed like their defensive line really set the tone by their aggressive play, taking it to the backfield of Notre Dame.
Yeah, they really did. You know, and our defensive front allowed us to play the